Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the 2022 QFA Div 2 South Reserve Seniors Grand Final between Carrara and Coolangatta. AFL Queensland is deeply saddened by the passing of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. Her grit, humility and devotion to the Commonwealth will be remembered by all long after her reign. May she rest in peace. We ask everyone to remove their hats and to those who can, be upstanding for a minute's silence. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the Australian National Anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the QFA Division 2 South Grand Final. I'm Jack Barrett. I'm joining the commentary today by Kane Browning. Kane, welcome aboard. A big game here today. We've got Coolangatta, the Mighty Blues, taking on Carrara Saints in this Division 2 Grand Final here at Surface Paradise today.
No, thank you, Jack. Pleasure to be here on a beautiful day for footy. And I tell you what, come Grand Finals, mate, everything's on the line. And that first 10 minutes is going to be absolutely crucial for both these sides. It looks to be Coolangatta have had the moxie on Carrara last time they played. They got on top by 40 points in the end in a semi-final. So it should be interesting. The first 5 minutes are going to be crucial for both sides and really interesting to see who stands up for either side today.
Well, the crowd is slowly starting to build. And then we'll have a look at the field umpires for today. Field umpires for today's game. We've got Stephen Betts and Ben Cousins and Mark Buick from and also from our boundary umpires, George Dean and Max Dean. Our goal umpires are Joe Bull and Liam Kelly, and our emergency umpire is Lachlan Jones. Of course, Carrara coached by Shane Madeley and the captain by Jaden Brennan, and it's been a good rebuild and good build-up from Carrara. They've been a club that's played in the lower division since they've got into this competition. They've been slowly built up and now they're into a grand final. They've done a magnificent job.
No, we were talking to the assistant coach, Wayne Pettard, earlier, and he was saying exactly that, Jack. Slow build the last two or three years, and they've picked up a number of players, and they've come leaps and bounds during the season. So, again, once you make the grand final, it's not about just making it. You want to win it if you can get there. So both these sides really keen to get on top early.
And, of course, Coolangatta are coached by Matt Ashenden, of course a school teacher, but also done a fair bit of coaching in Brisbane before taking up the reins here, and the captain was Scott Reardon. So again, Coolangatta, they won their last premiership 20 years ago. And of course, back in the 80s, they were a very strong football club and used to go head-to-head with Southwards in some epic grand finals here on the Gold Coast all those years ago. But again, they've had their challenges over the years, but new facilities, and they're building slowly, and they're getting better and better each year. So really looking forward to them. Of course, we've got some big names playing the players that people might be aware of. Of course, for Coolangatta, Joel Tippett, the former AFL, VFL and Sandford player. Okay, he looks like a great player. Also, we've got Jed Turner in the ruck, who was a Meaful star that played across a few clubs. Aspley played in Sydney and also at Southport.
No, and Western Tate Turvey, obviously, is the reigning league best and fairest at this level from last year, 2021. So he looks to be lining up in that midfield battle today.
And also, we've got a very good midfield group with Carrara, and also looking forward to watching their skipper, Jaden Brennan, play. He's had a great year, had 9 best on grounds for his 10 best tonight. But anyway, we're not far away. We've got Coolangatta kicking to the left of the screen. It is a bit of a swirly wind out there today, Kane.
No, it definitely is, and very open Surfers Paradise Football Club, the ground here. And once that wind picks up, especially when it's pushing straight across the ground like it is at the moment, it can be a little bit difficult for the goal kickers to kick accurately. So.
Yes, up they go for the first quarter of the grand final. It's tapped out in forward to Carrara's way. They're going to jump onto the ball first. A big shepherd off the ball. Plowns are called by the umpire. A quick soccer off the umpire. The umpire's picked out a free kick. And it'll be a high contact. And it'll be a free kick there going to Sam Cunnington. And Cunnington has played a little bit of QAFL and NEAFL footy. Had a stint at Redlands and also over at Morningside. A bit of Broadbeach.
Bit of push and shove here across half forward between the two sides. No love lost between these two, that's for sure.
Cunnington just goes sideways and kick it out towards Brennan. That's Heath Brennan. Brennan spreads it out to the wing. Nice little kick there and finds himself Daniel Gross. Gross looking inboard now. He's going to straighten up. Hits towards the true centre forward. He's got a couple of players free. But it's intercepted there by Coolangatta. They're swooping on the ball. Numbers are going to support Coolangatta. They're trying to keep the ball alive. A quick kick away there by Hamilton into the forward line. But it's chopped off in defence. And there's a good mark there taken by Lopez.
No, it was really good to see Dylan King come across from half back and was able to cut off that intercept kick through that corridor, and they were almost away, Coolangatta, but great mark across half back for Carrara. Looks like both these sides just feeling each other out in these early stages. Both ruckmen now go up. No one can clearly win, and it looks like going to be another ball up.
Really interesting battle here between Turner, number 27 for Goulburn, also Betson, trying to get front spot. Taken away. Langan centres the ball all the way towards the commentary wing. Packs themselves. A trot mark in front by the skipper. Lowndes are cool. He's tackled heavily. Handball out the side. A quick kick forward. Here's a chance for the little speeding carry, but it's swooped it back on. Guys over the ball. Handball away there by Goyne. Now swiftly picked up there by Gross. They're going to take the ball through the middle of the ground. They have to be quick. He does through airs. And he picks it along there, but it's chopped off by Coolangatta under the defence there by number 32. Ben Elliott.
No, they look really well set up behind the footy, Coolangatta, in these early stages as they move to push the ball down the line now on that far side wing. Good chip-in kick forward. Maybe looking to get back it through the corridor. No, decides to go out a bit wider. This will be a kick inside attacking 50. Takes one bounce. Kicks to the hot spot. Guys go up. No mark taken. Ball comes to ground. Kick off the ground. Goal! Great goal there by the Coolangatta Blues, and they've got the first one on the board. They've got a 6-point lead, and we've played just over 2.5 minutes in this opening quarter, Jack.
Great little start there. The ball hit the back there, and it quickly swooped on the footy. Couldn't quite pick up who kicked that goal, but it was a good goal of the Blues, and that's the start they were looking for.
No, great effort. Just running in waves through the corridor there. Decided to go out a little bit wider. Kicked it to the hot spot, big full forward, went up, couldn't take the mark, ball came to ground, great front and centre, and a good kick off the ground for the opening goal.
So it's 6 points, the lead for Coolangatta. They got the first one of the day. Umpire taking the ball back into the middle. But Turvey in there, take Turvey, the umpire throws it up, Turner. Oh, it's a nice tap out the back, well done there by the ruckman in Betson. Ball spills free, here's a chance, a soccer off the ground. There by Elliott, picked up by Carrara.
They go here forward. We go.
Here's a chance. It feels free. They've got pressure to do. Gets it on the right foot. Kicks it to the forward line, but it's got too much on it. It's over line and out of bounds on the full.
No, great pressure there by the Coolangatta back line. Just put enough pressure on to miss the kick inside attacking 50. Could have had a shot on goal as well, so great effort there.
Manane goes short. Oh, he can't take the mark, and the ball spills over the line and out of bounds. So Manane's had a couple of touches early, number 7. The umpire will ball it. I feel like the breeze, it's a half a big, probably biting, coming across the ground there, Kane.
No, it's a bit swirly, actually, at the moment. It seems to be coming and going, but Coolangatta seem to be on top in these early stages. Carrara need to get their hands on the footy because they've had very little influence in the first few minutes.
Big CD doing the ruck work in the forward line there. Of course, kicked a ton of goals in the reserves, but certainly a strong marking forward if they can get the ball down quickly for him. He's only in front spot. Tapped over the back there by Turner. Sharked away by Coolangatta. It's just a soccer kick off the ground. A handball forward. Here's a chance. Get onto the left foot. Drives it in forward. Here's a chance where he's pushed under the ball. Umpire says play on. Snaps out of the back of soccer off the ground. Bounces forward. Here's a snap up. Pressure on the Coolangatta defence. Panic stations. Handball. Can't get the ball clear. Here's a snap for goal by number 9. Whoa, that was Joshie Nelson. It goes through for a point, but a chance now for Coolangatta to reset.
Yeah, Nelson was in a great spot front and centre. Just couldn't get quite a good purchase on his kick and snuck it in from behind. But you're right there, Jack. This is going to get a chance to get our defence.
The old champion, Hawkins, a beautiful kick here, a superstar on the Gold Coast for a long period of time.
Oh, danger.
Short and it's been chopped off. That's a good little play there by Ayres. Windy conditions, swirly conditions. Ayres looking to go inboard. The left footer pops it up. It's going to be sucked into the corridor to the flank, and it goes out of bounds in the pocket. And there'll be a throw-in by the umpire.
It's going to be very, very interesting to see. You'd probably be wanting to go inside 50 on that far side rather than the shallow side because that breeze is going to bring it from left to right. And he was lucky to that ball went out of bounds and not out of bounds on the full.
Nice tap out there by City. Sharked away there by Ayres, who's been busy in this first turn.
Oh, crunch.
Umpire plays the advantage in their way, but the numbers are going to suit Carrara if he can take the mark. Ball spills free. Looking for a shepherd. Good forward pressure. A tackle in the middle of the ground. Running straight through. That's great play there by Kerr. Kerr drives it long into the forward line, but it's got too much on it. It's going to roll out of bounds. And it'll go out of bounds inside forward 50. But unless it's on the attacking side this time, Kane.
No, Carrara have had the last probably minute just being able to lock that ball inside attacking 50 and just building that wall across their half forward line so Coolangatta can't get easy exits.
To bring the ball in. Coolangatta numbering up. Carrara trying to put the pressure on, get the next goal on the board. Turner, big fist. Well done, but it's sharked away. Again, it's a high tackle. Umpire says play on. There's a snap out the back. Here's a chance now. They're just trying to put numbers now. It's quickly kicked away through the middle of the ground. This might suit Carrara. There's a fist. That's a good, strong mark. Play on's a call. And it'll be taken away now. They go backwards to go forwards. Good play. And it's kicked away there by Carey. Into the true centre wing, and now they're off to the races. One bounce, they have to go quickly. He's been run down. Handball over the top towards Carey. Up, I said you dropped the ball. Bring it back, thanks, Cooley. Good run down and carry by Carrara. Good pressure. Good turnover, Kane.
No, and genuine speed shown there by the Carrara player. He was brilliant on that occasion, being able to run it down. Comes in board. Good mark taken.
This is Gross.
Gross. Gross looking to go inside attacking 50. Ball comes in now. Players fly high. No mark taken. Ball comes over the back. Coolangatta all the numbers here. And come out from defence, Jack.
Drives into the front. Packs himself from mark. That's a lovely mark in front. And he's off ball. He's fallen over at the last second. That was McMurdy. He kicks over the top, but it's going to be chopped off. And mark in defence here to Gross once again.
Gross has started really well across that half back line. He's taken a couple of intercept marks. And he's seen up well in defence.
Former Geelong amateur, he kicks the ball out wide. Now he's found his teammate in Kerr. Kerr takes the game on through centre half-back. Handball's over the back, and Carrara going to reset from the true centre half-back position and drop.
Good kick.
And it's that man again. He's been busy. That's Ayres again. Gets onto the right foot this time and sets it up, but it's going to be chopped off. Punch clear. Good pressure there. Defence in for the forward line by Carrara. Now it's cool, kicked away from Coolangatta.
Here we go.
And they're out again. And it's young Carey, Mitch Carey. He kicks the ball out wide. Now there's a chance to go inside 50. Looking for his tip of the full forward. The ball running over the top. Is he going to go through? He got it in the left foot. Has a step around the corner. That's through. This through to the kicks his first. That was a good build up, Kane. Again, a good forward pressure there, but when the ball spilled free, Coolangatta able to clear the ball and run it out.
No, Kerry was the one on that far side. He's been able to break clear on a couple of occasions, get into some open space. He's actually coming to the bench now, but was able to kick over the line and allowed Tipper to run into an open goal and a great left foot snap on the in the end of it.
Coolangatta, two straight 12, leading Carrara, one behind in the QFA 2 division. Division 2 South Grand Final here, played at Surfers Paradise in the beautiful Gold Coast. And we've got, as we said, blustery conditions, but it's been nice and hot at the early days.
Now, the wind seems to be coming from left to right, so it's favouring Carrara's end at the moment, but they need to get the hands on the ball through that midfield group.
Turner got the hap out and he backs
good
it up.
Good tackle.
Cuts a quick handball away. This is going to suit Carrara now. They get onto the right foot and just kick it nice, kick forward, and there's a nice mark there taken by Gentle. Gentle looking for a teammate. He kicks it forward, packs out himself, but it's going to be all Coolangatta, and it's that great man in Hawkins. Hawkins goes through the middle of the ground. He's going to have to hit his target. Punched over the back. Good defensive work there by Brennan. Ball spills free. Now they're out here, Coolangatta, through the likes of Lanyon. Lanyon kicks up there, looking for his forward. Going hard there is McMurdy, but it's pushed over the boundary line, and it's good defence there, taken away by Harry Kerr, who's also started well. So the defence of Kerr. And also, who'd we say before, the other young bloke, was number 20, I think it was, in Gross, in defence, have been really strong.
No, those key position spots down back are so important, especially in grand finals early on. They've been able to take a couple of intercept marks. And the key thing for both sides, the tackling pressure, and they've been able to keep their feet. They're not fumbling, which is good to see.
Ball gets tapped forward, trying to shark away, getting in first is Carrara. They all play stacks on the mill out by says, I'll have it, thank you.
Now, there's not a player back of centre for either side. It's all down this end. Every single player is lined up in front of centre here, which is interesting.
A quick snap away from goal is taken. You can see Bo Kelly here in defence for Coolangatta, telling his players to push back out, open up some space in the forward line. So exactly what you were saying. Turner started off really well in the ruck, but it'll be Carrara now to bring the ball in from fullback. Will they attack the outer wing, Kane?
Possibly. They definitely don't want to come out to this left-hand side.
It's a lovely kick too. It's going to land out in the wing there. Big Seedy sets himself, but he gets underneath the ball. Ball spills free, but again, it's Ayres, who's been really busy early. Gets a quick kick away, racing towards the boundary line, and it gets taken out of bounds right in front of the hot yoga little business over there, and they'll throw the ball in, Kane.
Geez, you'd love to see Scotty Ayres as a heat map. If we had the ability to check the heat map in these early stages, he's probably had 6 or 7 touches in this first quarter, and he's really shown some poise in the opening quarter.
Certainly been busy. Umpire throws it in. Turner again gets a tap out. Again, is that Ayres again? A big kick forward. Started off like a house on fire. Ball bounces over the top and rolls out of bounds, and the ball will be thrown in as we approach the 11.5-minute mark of the first term of this grand final between Coolangatta in the navy blues and the Saints in the Carrara in the white strip today.
Looks like they've got that spare Coolangatta right on the goal line, just in case that quick kick comes out from this boundary throw-in.
That probably means an extra at the stoppage. Ball bouncing around in the packs, but it'll just play a bit of stacks on the mill and just congest it up. And you can see if they win this ball, Coolangatta out of this, there's numbers back there that are going to suit Carrara to go back in for another forward entry. So they'll have to be careful. Again, Ayres, a quick kick away into the hot spot. Hawkins, Cool under pressure. They'll switch the ball out, and they're out, Coolangatta, and away they go. No, he holds it up. He's looking for a teammate. He's going to take his time. Handball's over the top. He's found Robinson. Robinson gets onto the left foot, drives it long, but he's got no one home. This was what we were talking about. The ball's going to bounce and set up for, that looks like it's Kerr again. Goes inboard and finds his teammate, and it's a two bites of the cherry, and it's Nick Gentle once again. Gentle goes in short and finds his teammate. That's a good mark there to Rockcliffe.
Rockcliffe now, right foot kick to the hot spot. Geez, mark that, boys. 2-on-1 here. The big fella goes up, can't take the mark. Ball rolls through. No one's getting a clear possession on the footy. Handball back in board. Great smother by the Blues on that occasion. And they kick the ball straight to Kelly. Kelly marks across half back, Jack.
Kelly looking in board. That was good work there. Drives along in front of the commentary ring. The packs out themselves. Numbers are going to suit. Oh, the skipper, Reardon, a good mark. Gets pushed over, a bit of a bump, and he's often playing on. Brings the ball in the middle of the ground, he sits it up. This is going to suit both players, they both hits the field right on the money, taken away. Here's a chance for Coolangatta. They can ring, string the handballs together. A quick kick away there by number nine in Hamilton. Who's he got? And he's found his teammate. And it's a good mark in the forward line by Joshy Fenton.
Now, Coolangatta's ability to run in waves through that corridor, they've done it on three or four occasions in this opening quarter. Carrara don't seem to have an answer. They seem to be backpedaling rather than pushing up to attack the player with the footy. And all of a sudden, they've had three numbers rain inside 50, and a great mark there by the young man. Number four in Josh Fenton.
Fenton comes in. Can they put Coolangatta's third on the board? Oh, he drills it through to the middle, but he wasn't going to stick it up nice and high. He was going to try and laser it through, but offline and through for one behind.
Like I said earlier, Jack, once that breeze starts coming across the ground, it's very hard to get ball to boot, especially when you're probably beyond 25, 30 metres out.
Cunnington back onto the ground for Carrara as the ball's taken to the back pocket there. Looking around, eyes darting around. Who's he got? Is he going to go short or go along the line? He's got a nice little lead taken there. And it's taken there by Hollands. Hollands, the youngster, just sits the ball up. Finds Spittle. Spittle still in defence. Outside, just right on the 50-metre line. He's looking to go across. That's dangerous there. Oh, he's going to take it on. No, he decides. He takes. He just draws him out and brings a chance. And that's to Holland. So Holland once again.
Now, I think they're aiming to come trying to switch the ball at the ground because they know this side of the ground, the ball's going to be pushed towards the boundary line. As Coolangatta cut it off again.
That's Tippett.
That's Tippett. Tippett's had a good start of this quarter as well. Brings plenty of experience. Left foot kick just on the edge of 50. Oh, what a mark!
Man!
No! Oh! Oh! Talk about climbing the ladder. No mark taken, unfortunately. Did everything but hold on to the footy. That was a huge leap, Jack.
Yeah, thrills and spills here today. Umpire throws it up.
That was gross again, too.
Tapped away. Both teams. Now they'll clear it away. Carrara goes in short, lowers his eyes, but it's cut off there by Jed Turner, and he takes it over the line and out of bounds and causes a stoppage for the Mighty Blues.
Jeez, Jed Turner. Big body, big ruckman.
Yeah, had a stellar career in state league footy, as I said, across Queensland and also New South Wales.
As he would. He's one player. He can win the game off his own boot today.
Strong.
Oh, crunch. That's okay. Bring a bit of aggression. Don't have to be stupid about it. Now, Carrara's had a knack of doing this little chip, chip, chip. It's all well and good, but it allows Coolangatta to sit up behind the footy and be able to get that extra number up to punch the ball away.
Go through the middle. He's got too much on it. And Turner's there, who's pushed in defence. Takes the ball. Turner on the left foot. Goes down the line. Looking for Tippett. He's got two to beat. But there's a big fist coming across there by Ethan Mackey. And the ball goes out of bounds.
And that's where it becomes a bit predictable, Jack. Slow ball movement means both defences can set up that extra man. They know exactly where the ball's going to go. Tippett had a two-on-one there and was never going to mark it.
Ball goes, got a bit on that one. Goes out the back. Umpire has picked out a Shepherd. And it'll be a free kick going to Carrara through the ruck there. And it's going to be taken away by Betson. Betson sends it out wide. That's
good
a
kick.
Lovely kick. Found his teammate on the outer flank. Looking inboard. He goes inside now. Takes the game on. Now it's a big long kick there. Looking for the big fella in seat.
Look at that.
Oh, yeah. He had the sit. His big, strong presence up forward. Of course, his father, Paul, was a champion at Southport. And also, I think he might have played a bit of footy at Palm Beach. But the young fella, as I said, looking up his stats, a couple of months ago, he kicked a lot of goals in the reserves. I think he's had a bit of a foot injuries, but he's certainly a strong presence up there forward, and he's going to line up for his first today. Dane Seedy comes in to put Carrara's first on the board, and he puts it straight through and gives them the old heave-ho. Let's go. And the Saints get their first. And it's now Coolangatta 2-2-14, leading Carrara 1-1-7. Kane at the 17, approaching the 80-minute mark, first term.
Now, that's the thing, too. When you've got a player who's got the ability with their penetrating kick, kicking with the breeze, just being able to kick over that line, that spare man in defence that Coolangatta had, and the big fella came across the pack and took a brilliant mark and got their first one on the board.
So So a good start by, at the end of the day. It's as I said, they moved to 1-1-7, only 7 points of difference. So it's been a if they can get another one, they're right back in it, and they had their moments where they've looked pretty strong.
Coolangatta have had the ascendancy in this opening quarter, but they haven't quite got the inside 50s to match.
Umpire throws it up. Seedy's gone into the ruck now, but it's going to be trying to be taken away there by Lanyon.
Oh, crunch.
Big, strong tackle in the middle of the ground. The umpire says, I'll have it there, thank you. So both men will take Turvey in there, having a bit of a push and shove, but settled down, of course, the medalist from last year. Umpire throws the ball up. Uncontested this time. Coolangatta got to clear the ball out. Sweeping on the ball. Carrara trying to win the ball. That was Ralph. Umpire says, I'll have it again, thank you.
Now they're one on one. Coolangatta inside attacking 50. So Carrara decided to do even numbers of the contest.
Umpire taps it, throws it up again. It's just tapped straight to another contest. So no one can win the footy and get a good clearance out there. It's getting quite congested, but holding a little bit of width out there is Coolangatta. So it'll be trying to win the ball and get a quick hands out. Nice tap out by Seedy. Now it's sharked away by the Saints, but it's all going to sit there nicely for Manane. He kicks it out wide. Beautiful play. Nice little play there by Lanyon. Coolangatta away. Here's a chance now going inside 50. Delays a cutter, but again, just cut off by Carrara.
Oh, and kick.
He's got too much on it. I think the ball might have hit the ground. And the umpire says, I'll have a thank you.
Geez, great tackle at the end by Ralph, because Coolangatta had three extra numbers of that contest. If the ball had come out, they were going inside to attacking 50 again.
Again, well sharked away. Here's a chance. Got a nice left foot kick away there by Cotty. He kicks the ball high, but it's going to be all Coolangatta back there as they win the ball.
I believe that's Kelly again. Number 11.
That's
yes, it is.
Kelly goes in short. A good finds. Another guy who's played really well is Manane. Manane finds his teammate in Milroy. Milroy on the wing. So Bruce Ball Park at Surface Paradise. Off he goes. Uses the stand rule, kicks it long down the line, spills over the back. Here's a chance now to be picked up by Brennan. They win the ball. Handball goes astray. Back on it. They go back to go
for
it.
Tackle.
Oh, he gets the handball away just in time. They'll get a quick kick away. Is it going to suit? Coolangatta's got the numbers at the back. Carrara win the footy. He's tackled high. Umpire says play on. Kicked high again. Back down the line, but it's going to be Big Seedy in the front spot, who's doing a good job in the ruck since he's moved in there, Kane.
Yes, he definitely has. He kicked that first goal and decided to move into the ruck. He's had the ascendancy the last couple of tap-outs. Shocking kick in board, though. Here's Carrara's chance, though. Oh, brilliant tackle. That's got to be gone, and is.
Well, the umpire says not paying the advantage, so that's good there by the little star in Tate Turvey. He's got the ball at the true centre-half forward position.
Sorry,
it's going to go to Roy's.
Now, we've got Robinson in this broadcast forward pocket here, screaming for the footy. No one within 15 metres of him.
It's gone short. Let's play on. A quick kick away. That might be Whitehead. It goes over the top. Here's a chance now. Spinning around is Joel Tippett. Gets on a little kick, six to the hot spot. No one can take the mark.
Good mark.
No, not paid. Says played off too many hands. He says, I'll have it, thank you. So, kick it to that danger spot. It's pressure.
Jeez, hot spot footy there. But, again, Carrara just absorbing a bit of the pressure at the moment, which is really good to see because they started a bit slow.
Kicks away. Carrara. Now the ball spills free, but racing on the ball. They've got some really good leg speed. That looks like that was Carey. There's the two Carey boys out there today, and that certainly had a little bit of pace around the packs.
No, Daniel Carey, geez, talk about closing speed. He zoned in on that footy and was able to push it over the line. But again, all the numbers getting pushed up to the ground. There's a bit of push and shove deep inside attacking 50 for Coolangatta. Nothing happening there as far as the umpire is concerned.
Seedy and Watson did the ruck work. The ball goes out of bounds and it'll be back in again.
It's the other Carey brother in Mitch, number one, and number three, Brad Goyne, just matching up beautifully deep inside 50. The two smallest players down there, they're the ones doing the pushing and shoving.
Well, all the players on the other side, we've got players lined up here waiting to try and get back on the ground, but they can't. But here's a chance now, a quick kick here, high.
Oh,
good mark behind.
No, play on.
Must have been touched. And the umpire says, I'll have it, thank you. They can't get the changes because the ball is over the far side. So Coolangatta got Turner on the bench. They've got Robinson. They've also got McMurphy just sitting here.
Good tackle. Here's Carrara's chance right now, Jack, if they move the ball quickly.
Oh, he's panicked and played on. Coolangatta swoop back on the ball. Umpire says, a lot of stoppages today. I'll have the ball again. So a little bit of frustration building in.
Just a little bit of polish Carrara needs at the moment. They've been a little bit fumbly at the worst possible times, and they're teeing the ball over in dangerous spots.
Big CD's come off the ground. He's swapped with his ruckman in Betson, so Betson's back on. So they've got a bit of a chance here while Turner's stuck on the bench over here for Coolangatta. They can't ring any changes. But again, it's just stoppage footy here as the clock ticks away. 23, 24 minute mark coming up as we 2-2-14, Coolangatta leading Carrara 1-1-7, QFA Division 2 grand final here on the south. Of course, the north grand final was played yesterday and won by the Hinterland Blues over Alexandra Hills. It'll be a free kick here now to Coolangatta. They go inside 50. No one can take the mark. Spills out the back there. Here's a chance for Lopez, trying to keep the ball alive. Swooped on the ball was Ralph. The ball goes out of bounds and they'll be throwing inside Coolangatta's forward 50 game.
Geez, Carey screaming to the umpire for a free kick. He thought he was held without the ball, but no free kick paid. But I tell you what, Coolangatta, especially Kelly. Kelly seems to be the mastermind for that back line, just setting up beautifully. There's not been a player from Carrara go anywhere near in this entire quarter. He's had 50 metres of space in every direction all quarter, which is really interesting considering he's a key defender.
That was a good exit there from Carrara. Now they'll switch the ball across.
Dangerous kick.
He's gone across the floor. Oh, they've both come unstuck. Here's a chance. The numbers are going to suit Carrara as he runs right towards the boundary line. He's going to kick the ball in. Oh, he's taking the ball out of bounds. And that was Jordan Andrews, the vice captain. I think he might not have thought he had too much to kick to, so he's happy to cause a stoppage in front of the commentary wing here. And look at now all the changes coming. It's like the Formula One pit stop. They're in for the pits, and numbers are spinning around, but haven't got Big Turner on yet. Throw the ball in, front spot, spills out the back. Now it's going to be taken away there through Brennan, the skipper. He kicks the ball forward, but the ball bounces over the top of Hollands. Now it's picked up. Oh, that was Ayres. Can he get a free kick? Playon's a call.
He's dived on it. No. And again, Coolangatta was set up beautifully there. The ball, just the bounce of the ball. They had the right idea, Carrara, being able to chip the ball in short, drop the eyes, but wasn't able to hit the target.
Throw the ball up. Turner. Big kick out. Handball punch, over the top there. Trying to swoop on the ball. Working hard there is Carrara. Can they win the ball? Now the ball gets free. Who's the lead speed going to suit? Coolangatta, good below his knees. Under pressure
good
there.
Good tackle.
Robinson, he's just come on the ground. There's a bit going on behind the ball. There's two players sort of coming together, but umpire says just settle it down as the wind is really starting to pick up here.
Geez, Watson was really good. Clean, solid tackle and bring him to ground and lock the ball in.
No one can get a clear tap away then as the two players rest from themselves, and Spittle comes in there with a solid tackle for Carrara. The Saints down by 7. Turner. Big strong fist forward. Here's a chance for Coolangatta. Tries to centre the ball inside. Ball bounces over the top. Oh, sharked away. Handball over the top. Racing onto the ball is Lanyon. Can he get there first? Ducks and weaves. Spins around. Oh, Sonny's a handball. Gets a quick kick away. Good pressure. No one can take the mark. Plowns a call. Still going. And the siren's gone as we close the first quarter of this QFA Division 2 South Grand Final. It's Coolangatta 2-2-14, leading Carrara 1-1-7. We'll be back after this break and get some comments with Kane before we start the second term. Welcome back to Sir Bruce Small Oval here in Surface Paradise for the QFA Division 2 Grand Final in the South. And it's Coolangatta taking on Carrara. And it's Coolangatta 2-2-14 leading Carrara 1-1-7. I'm joined in the commentary box for the second term by Kane Browning. And Kane, give us your thoughts on the first term, on how it played out.
Now, Coolangatta definitely had the ascendancy early on. They were very clean with the footy, and they were very well set up behind the footy as well. So every time Carrara did get a chance to go inside 50, they had that spare man in Kelly that seemed to be coming across, taking intercept marks for every time the ball went in there. But I did like Carrara's work rate at the back end of that quarter. They started to get some ascendancy across half back and being able to push the ball with speed. They need to move with speed going inside attacking 50, because you've got the big fella down there in Seed. Seed one-on-one, they haven't got a matchup to go with him, so if they can get him one-on-one, he might be able to take two or three contested marks and have a couple of shots on goal. But Cooling, it seems to be even Steven at the moment, and the scoreboard seems to dictate that as well.
Goal kickers for Coolangatta, Joel Tippett has one, and Scott Reardon, the skipper, also has one. He kicked the first for the day. And Daniel Seedy, the bloke you were talking about who's lining up a full forward, also has one for Carrara. So, yep, Manane, Turner, Hawkins have been really good for Coolangatta, and we like the game of Ayres, Gross and Kerr, just to name a few in these early stages. Umpires, obviously brought to you by Bradman's Windows and Doors. Here we go for the second term. It'll be Coolangatta kicking to the right of screen this time, and also Carrara, obviously wearing the white strip. Tapped away, Turner gets his hands on it first. Sweeping on the ball there was Milroy, and the umpire for Coolangatta, and the umpire says, I'll have it again. So we've had a fair few stoppages today. We think the wind is blowing probably across the ground. The two rucks are Betson. He gets a quick handball. That tackled high. Play on's a call. Ball spilling free. Can Coolangatta clearance? No, it's taken away beautifully there by Goyne as he kicks it forward. Swooped on. Great play.
Good tackle.
Trying to horse his way through. The umpire says, you're caught. You took the game on. And it'll be a free kick in defence there to number 32 in Elliott. He switches play. Finds his teammate in Whitehead. Whitehead looking down the ground. Is he going to bring the ball in? It'll be interesting to see how he plays this. He's going to go long down the line. Drills it in there. It's going to be cut off by Gross, who's had a great first term.
Including almost taking mark of the century. Cut. Unfortunately, though, bad kick in board. Coolangatta cut it off. Kicks inside attacking 50 now. One-on-one, push and shove. Here's Tippett again. Tippett slips over, can't get clear. And this is Gross again. Chips the ball. Ayres doesn't go up. Carrara's chance now, kicks in board, and a great mark taken by Betson.
Betson, the ruckman, mobile ruckman, kicks the ball down the line.
Good kick.
Oh, big CD all by himself. They've left him unattended at centre half forward. He moves it quickly. He's going to go long.
Good kick again.
He's got Osman down there, and he's taken the mark uncontested about 25 metres out from goal. Direct or about a 45-degree angle. And he'll have a shot for goal. Excuse me.
Frog in the throat, Jack.
The Exed Nyora down the Allen Bank League. I think they're the Allen Bank League down there. And, of course, having a shot for goal. Coming in. He's kicked 32 this year. And this 33rd is really important. He comes in. Oh,
coming back.
It's a beautiful kick. Well, the boy. Of course, Nyora of the Saints as well. So, sorry. Good goal there to Ian Osman. He kicks his first for the day. And now that swings the score to a point the difference. Coolangatta 2-2-14, leading Carrara 2-1-13. And a big mark there, uncontested by Seedy, the man you're talking about at the start of the quarter at centre half forward. Got the break they wanted.
No, it also started across half back as Gross got the intercept and then decided to take the risky kick, but it came off through that corridor. And all of a sudden they were away. Brilliant kick to the big fella. And then the big fella was smart, moved the ball quickly into Osman. And Osman, a great finish on that occasion with that breeze blowing right into his face.
Back in the middle. Umpire throws the ball up. A good tap away then by Betson. He's lifted his work rate. But it's marked in defence there by Coolangatta of the true centre half-back position. Will he favour the outer wing? He's going to go up the middle of the ground. The lead. Reardon, punched out of his hands, spilled over the chance. Here's a chance here for Robinson, if he can get the ball, but Carrara are working hard. He's got three to beat. He's going to happy try and see that ball go out of bounds and over the line. Yes, he does. Clever there, play there by Goyne.
Oh, high tackle, too.
What's happened here? It's a free kick to Coolangatta of a late high tackle. That's by the it's Carrara. I thought so. And he'll take the ball. So again, a little win there for Carrara. He had three to beat, and he's also picked up the free kick. Crowd getting restless. Drives the ball right in front of the commentary. The pack flies, big fist, and punched away there by Manane, who's had a good start to the game for Coolangatta, the number seven.
No, Nelson went up. A little bit unlucky not to get a free kick for a bit of a push once he got off the ground, but good effort there by the young man.
Umpire throws the ball in. Turner trying to get the front spot. No, but it's punched out the back. Here's a chance now there by Ayres, who's been really busy. A quick kick away there by Tate Turvey. But
good effort.
Gets on the right foot, kicks it high. No, the big fist by Turner. Well, good front and centre. Beautifully taken there by McMurdy. Kicks there towards Tippett. Drifts with the feet. Tate Turvey's there. Gets on the kicks it nicely.
Good
weighted
work.
Kick. And, he's taken a mark. A lovely mark there to what Jakey Whitehead. And the former Wilson Grange player will have a shot from goal directly in front. About 15 metres out from goal, probably 15, 20 metres out from goal.
Now, that was just about being clean, Jack. He had Tippett that ran out from full forward, clean with the hands, was able to handball off to Tate Turvey, who brilliantly had great vision and was able to set up in Whitehead leading, running inside attacking 50.
Whitehead comes in. The studded run. He drives it straight through the middle, and he's got his first. So a good goal there to Jake Whitehead, and Coolangatta the third. And you're right on the money there, Kane. I thought Tate Turvey, then you can see why he's been... he gets under the umpires. He just composed, waited his kick, kicked to advantage, and a nice clean mark there by Jake Whitehead to put his first through. So Coolangatta, 3-3-20, leading Carrara 2-1-13 here at Surface Paradise at the Suabruth Small Oval. In a beautiful Sunday Queensland day on the Gold Coast, Kane. Where would you rather be?
Oh, you wouldn't rather be anywhere else today, I tell you. Again, the only thing that's given a bit of grief is that breeze. It's going to the Coolangatta end, so Carrara's got to be careful that Coolangatta don't get three or four on the board in the second quarter.
Betson gets a kick away, but it's turned over and found by Nick Hamilton. He goes in short, finds his teammate in the middle of the ground. Coolangatta looking to surge again. Go through the big kick down the line. Looking for Tippett. He gets one bite. Ball spills through. Here's a chance here for Carey. If he can get on there, sweep on the ball. He's still got to keep the ball alive. He's going to dart around, get on the right foot, sticks around the corner. And it's a mark in the square.
Is that Tippett? I believe that's Tippett. No? No, that's not Tippett down there. Tippett's running, walking back in now.
I think that's the skipper. It's Reardon.
Number 23, Reardon.
Yep, that's the skipper. So he's lining up for his second, the captain. And Coolangatta put their fourth through as he just slots it through nice and easily. So two goals to Scotty Reardon. And it's, of course, he played a bit of footy down at Phillip Island and also a Shepparton. So he's played a little bit of country footy, but he's back up here playing on the Gold Coast and leading the Blues now in this grand final. 4-2-26, leading Carrara 2-1-13, Kane.
Now, Carrara got the first one in the quarter, was brilliantly set up trying to get... Got that margin back to 1 point, and all of a sudden Cooley's gone bang bang in the last minute and a half. Got another two on the board to answer straight back and push that lead out to 13 points.
Okay, they're about reset in the middle. It's the Blues by 13. 20 years since they won a premiership. Of course, Carrara going for their first up in this competition, doing a great job in the ruck. Beetson, he's really lifted his work rate this quarter. Kicked away here by Dylan King. Bouncing forward, it's going inside. Coolangatta's forward 50 game, but it's overrun. And it's taken away there by Kerr. Kerr drives the ball on the outer wing.
Got to go.
Oh, can he take the mark? Umpire says play on. Spills out the back. I'll have it, thank you. So good play by, again, Gross and Kerr. Two really strong rocks down there for Carrara, aren't they?
And Turner's seen up behind the play as well. Every chance he gets just to be that bit of a bigger body set up behind the ball. So it's very hard to take a contested mark against the likes of Turner there.
Another stoppage. Umpire throws the ball up. Tapped over the top. Again, Carrara bullocking their way through. Strong. Can't get the clearance, and the umpire will call it up again. So,
geez, the tackling from both these sides has been brilliant in this first quarter and a bit.
Yeah, not wanting to turn the ball over, are they? They're trying to keep contention. Here's a chance now. Quickly taken away there by McMurdy. He's been busy this afternoon. Bounces over the top, getting him jumping on the ball quickly there, Spittle. Handball's over the top again, but the ball will be pushed out of bounds and thrown in by the umpires. Of course, brought to you by Bradnam's Windows and Doors, who are great sponsors of our umpires here in Queensland this year.
Now, you just look at the space that you have in the Coolangatta forward line at the moment. They've got three players set up. Tippett sort of pushing up the ground. And the full forward down there, not quite sure he's down there for Cooley. There's a mountain of room to run into. Here he comes now. Oh.
This is where a dangerous ball spills free. They've got a hammer.
Good tackle by Tippett.
And they'll take the ball out of bounds. So Turner launched that ball. About 30, 40, 50 metre kick. It was a big kick. And it puts pressure straight on the Carrara defence. But they're happy to see the ball go out of bounds. And now they'll be looking to try and win this ball and get a clearance if they can. 4-2, 26. Nine minute mark. First turn has been a free kick off the ball. And it looks like it's going to go to Coolangatta. This is a bit of ill discipline. This is not what Carrara Saints need. And it's going to look like it might be a free kick to Josh Fenton.
Geez, Fenton's in a lot of strife on the ground here. He hasn't moved that much since the incident. I couldn't quite pick up what exactly happened there, but the umpires are right onto it.
It'll be a free kick, I think, unless it's been...
Is that a yellow card?
Not sure. It might be. Umpire, yes, it is a yellow card, so... I don't know if it's two yellow cards or one yellow card.
Geez, it might have been two yellow cards. Oh, not quite sure on that one.
So going off is Goyne and Spittle.
I think Goyne might have been the one to get the marching orders by the umpire on that occasion.
Well, the player is coming off the ground. Is coming off the ground, and we're having a shot on goal. Will be Mitch Carey has taken the kick for him, so holding his sternum area there, so maybe he might have caught one. So he'll go and get the trainers to have a look at him as he's replaced by Connor Robinson. And it'll be Mitch Carey, the former Coolangatta junior, who comes through. He kicks it nice and high, but
he's got
it through. I thought it might take it away, but it's got his first for the game. So Mitch Carey kicks that goal, and geez, the coaching staff at Crow won't be happy with that one. They weren't that far out of it. They were still working hard, but Coolangatta now 5-2-32, leading Carrara 2-1-13 at the 11-minute mark of the second term, Kane. That's one they didn't want to give up.
And again, the likes of Carey. Carey's so clean below his feet. He is a small player, but he's been clean. He hasn't fumbled at all day, and a great finish on that occasion. Well-deserved. And again, like you say, Jack, a bit of ill discipline. You just can't have that in grand finals. A lot on the line, and especially when you're in defensive 50, 20 metres out directly in front, practically.
Back in the centre, Carrara. Well, they want to bounce back and bounce back quickly. Umpire throws the ball up. Turner, the big fist, taken away there by Robinson, who's just come on the ground. He's tackled well. Good tackle there by Kerr. Ball spills out onto the wing. Numbers are suiting Carrara, but they just can't get that clean possession and get away. The pressure by the Coolangatta midfield. Look, them just all stormed over there to keep that tackle pressure up. And the ball spills over for a boundary throw-in.
And it looks like Heath Brennan is lining up on Mitch Carey, which seems to be a very interesting matchup down at half forward there for the Blues.
And below the, here's a chance now. It's through Ayres. The boy from WA kicks it long down the line. Punched over the top. Sharked away. Can they get the ball? No, it's going to be cleaned up there by Coolangatta. They kick the ball back down the line. The numbers are going to suit. And they're taking a good mark on the outer wing there by Robinson.
Geez, they had 4-on-2, Coolangatta. They're always going to win that contest if they manage to bring the ball to ground. And Carrara weren't quite good enough. Good mark. No, not paid.
That was Tippett that took the...
crunch. That's a great tackle.
Umpire says, I'll have it, thank you.
Geez, again, guys are not breaking tackles in this game at all this afternoon. Great work by both sides.
Yeah, their tackle pressure's been great. Here's a chance for Tippett. Quick handball away. Coolangatta go inside 50. They've got small fours up front. He just
good
moves
kick.
Him under the Ball spills out the back. They're going to be able a chance to clear the ball away. He turns him inside out, and he's got teammates to help him out. Here's a chance now there for Ralph.
Not a good handball.
Trying to keep it. It's Carey again. Get out of my way, he says.
Good
but
tackle.
It's strong tackle there by Ridley. And the umpire says, no, it doesn't reward him.
No. But again, brilliant, solid tackle. You're going to feel every tackle this afternoon. Everyone's going to be getting plenty of ice at halftime, I think.
So here's a chance for Carrara. They're trying to keep the ball alive. Umpire says, I'll ball it up, thanks. Trying to push the players back is Tippett. Trying to build that wall behind.
There we go. We've got Turner seen up just behind this play at the moment.
Yep. Here's a chance. Snap around the corner by McMurdy. It's high.
Jeez, mark that.
Yeah.
Oh.
The points are your friend. Here's a chance to reset. So we're approaching 14-minute mark. Second term. 5-3-33 Coolangatta. Carrara 2-1-13. 20-point ball game. Can they try and get a goal to narrow it down?
Geez, you'd love to see Carrara just snatch one just before half time here.
He hasn't got a lot of movement. He's going to go long. Turner's just sitting out the back, so he's going to have to be a big kicker. He's going to go straight to Turner. It's gone over his head, and he looked for a big.
Here we go.
He looked for a big CD. Couldn't take the ball. Here's a chance now. Carrara handball over the top. Now they've got number CD again. Nice handball inside. They're going to have to move it quickly. He's tackled and run down. He's got support, but no, hasn't got the support. He's after the umpire.
That's
says,
a throw.
You're throwing the ball. So good forward pressure there. And it's taken there in the back line there by on the wing there by James Elliott.
Geez, Coolangatta's ability to shut down space there. Oh, gee, what a. Oh, hang on. He's going to play front on contact, is he? Yes.
I thought he didn't quite get him.
Oh, good lead. Good mark by Tippett. Now, again, the ability. Carrara really struggling to get numbers back. They're pushing numbers up to the contest in the middle of the ground. But when Coolangatta get the intercept, Tippett shot on goal, cross the face, and out on the floor, misses everything. What I was saying, Jack, they're pushing the numbers up in the middle of the ground of the contest, but they're not working hard enough to get back across half back because the Coolangatta full forwards and deep forwards have a mountain of room to lead into. And with delivery like they did to Tippett then, they're going to take the mark every day of the week.
Hollins brings the ball out wide as a youngster, but unfortunately he's had too much on it. It's taken there by, I think, Whitehead. Goes inboard, kicks it right into the hot spot.
Tippett
sets himself. Oh, gutsy play.
Jeez.
And he went down hard too. Here's a chance now. It's at that man again. Carey.
No.
Around
no.
the corner. What a goal to Carey. Mitchie Carey kicks his second. And Coolangatta move out to a 6-3-39, leading Carrara 2-1-13. That was gutsy play and defence by the Carrara defender. Unfortunately, he couldn't get, he spoiled the ball, but unfortunately, the dangerous small man, when it hit the deck, just swooped on it.
And that's been a massive thing for the Coolangatta Blues today. Every time the ball, they are dominating when the ball hits the ground with their numbers and their pressure efforts. And the likes of Carey are having an absolute field day down there.
Big second term to the Blues as they're starting to assert their authority on this grand final. 16.5 minute mark, second term. Coolangatta 6-3-39, plays 2-1-13 for Carrara. Can the Saints bounce back? Can they get one? Just a bit of self-belief. The mighty Saints, up they go. Turner again, gets the tap. Kicked away this time by Carrara, sets himself for a mark. Good defence, good punch away. Again by Manone, he's been good in defence. So great snap out of the pack there by Betson, the ruckman who's toiling hard, and he's found CD. So CD now is a very important goal, a very, very important shot on goal. Can he kick it? He's second for the day.
Well, the distance might test him into this breeze. Plenty of numbers down there for Carrara in the goal square. If the ball drops short, it's going to take everything from this distance to get the ball over the line.
Dane CD. It's a nice, it looks beautiful off the boot. It's nice and high as it's swung around. Just offline for one behind. Certainly distance was no problem at all.
Now they've got to try and lock the ball in here, Carrara, and Coolangatta's gone bang. Moving the ball with speed, straight up the middle of the ground. Ball hits the contest. Ball comes down. Here's Carrara's chance now. Kicks the ball in short. No one can take the mark. Tried to tap the ball to Ayres. Ayres wasn't clean on that occasion. Handball's in board. Left foot kick on goal. Ball coming back. Just on that far side. Sneaks through for a behind. And here comes Coolangatta again, Jack.
Hawkins drives it long. That was a lot better build up there by Carrara this time. And they go back, a go inside 50 again. The pressure's on. Coolangatta trying to get those turnovers as they can. Handball out. Here's a chance for Carrara. They go in short. They're going to find his teammate. Just bounces short. Swooped on there by the Blues.
Good
handball
tackle
over the top. Pressure. They've lifted their work rate, the Saints. They want to get one. Kicks in board. The forward 50. Here's a chance all by himself. And he's taken a mark. And it's a good mark by the vice captain. I think that might be Jordan Andrews. And Jordy Andrews is going to have a shot on goal about 40 metres out from goal on probably a slight angle. And this is a lifting by one of the leaders. They need this goal. It's an understatement.
And all of a sudden they've had the ascendancy for the last probably 1 or 2 minutes. Jack going into half time. They really need to get a goal on the board though.
Coming in, Andrews. He kicks it high.
Look at
looks
that
pretty
for
good.
A kick.
He's got it.
There it is.
That's the one they wanted. Great goal there by Jordan Andrews, the ex-player from Tassie. I think he might have played a bit of footy at Devonport. That's a lovely goal, and that's the one they needed. So, Coolangatta 6-3-39, Carrara 3-3-21. We've played coming up to the 20-minute mark, 9.5-minute mark of the second term on this QFA Division 2 South Grand Final played here on the Gold Coast at the Surface Paradise Football Club.
Now, we were just talking before, Jack, about Coolangatta's ascendancy. When the ball hits the ground, they've been really dominant. All of a sudden, the last two times they've gone inside, or Coolangatta tried to clear it from defensive 50. As soon as the ball hit the ground, Carrara had a few numbers there. Been able to hit up a target inside 50 and have shots on goal, which has been good to see.
Hang on, as umpires found a free kick, I think we've got the mix of numbers here.
666.
They've got a 7 there. So Coolangatta will get their warning as they move the players back into the forward line, and the umpire will throw the ball up. So you're right, the work rate's picked up by their midfielders around the contest, Carrara, and they've sort of got their goal they want. There's still time if they can. Seedy, nice tap out of the center middle of the ground. Ducking and weaving there was Lanyon. They're going to keep the ball out. Turner, roosh, the left foot kick down forward. The pack set themselves, punched away there by Carrara defense. Snapped away,
easy.
A quick shot on goal, was quick snap there by Hamilton, but the ball goes through for one behind.
Geez, again, having so much space inside attacking 50 for your forwards to lead into, your smaller forwards know exactly where to run for front and centre, and that was almost too easy for the Blues on that occasion. Carrara couldn't get a man anywhere near them.
Nice kick out of there, finds Gross, centre halfback, handballs to his teammate in Brennan. Brennan sends it out wide, but it's too much. Oh, lovely mark.
Good grab.
That's Ayres. He's played a great game today, Ayres, when he's had his opportunities. Goes in short. Finds his teammate. That looks like it might... Can't quite pick up who it is. They'll switch it back across again. That's Gross again. He's having a good game. Gross looking for a bit of movement up forward. Of course, they've got Turner pushing back there in defence. They're going to just line it up and just kick it across. Finds Brennan. Brennan's going to look for the vice captain out there in Andrews. He kicked the last goal kicker. Andrews. Oh, he's kicked it out wide. The fist's going to come across. Good defence. Strong defence there by the Cooley number 12 and Matty Ryan.
Matty Ryan ran 60 metres to spoil that ball. Brilliant effort by Ryan.
Tippett looking to get back onto the ground. Coolangatta ringing the changes. Turner. Seedy in the ruck. Seedy trying to get front spot. No one can get it. Turner more mobile. Here's a chance now there by Robinson. He kicks the ball up again. Couldn't take the mark there. Was Hollins, who's been quite busy. Here's a chance now there for Gross. Gross kicks the ball down the line. Seedy's got the front spot, and he'll take a good, strong mark. What the look of this young fella. Not sure how old he is, but it's a good play. Kicks the ball down the line. Just abuses his body. Good work, and they're out. Handball over the top. Here's a chance here for Cody. He kicks onto the left foot, drives it long and high. Hawkins is sitting underneath
Look
the ball.
Look out!
Oh, the big punch over the top. Swooping on the ball there is Osman. He handballs back. He's going to be caught with the ball. Great tackle!
Was that
gone?
Turner? No, that wasn't Turner.
Great. It was a great tackle there by the Coolangatta defender. and he's caused a turnover when he was just about to set up another inside hotspot kick.
Geez, their closing speed has been elite this afternoon.
Big kick down the line. No one can take the mark. Bit of volleyball. So it's kicked high. His body. Couldn't take the mark. Good work there. Jumped on his Lopez. Handball out the back. Here's a chance now. Again for Betson. Betson onto the left foot. And it's going to be cut off in defence and taken there by that man we talked about in Matty Ryan.
Ryan now goes to the far side. Coolangatta should have taken the mark there. Brilliant tackle late though. Locks the ball in. Another ball up, says the umpire.
So that's great work by Watson a couple of plays back there. We run down and get that tackle because that was stopped a little bit of momentum that they had.
No, just that closing speed has been brilliant this afternoon, especially by the Blues. Carrara's got the numbers at the moment on that far side. No one can get clear possession though. Ball rolling towards the boundary line and goes over for another boundary throwing, Jack.
Andrews has certainly picked up his work ethic around the ground too, Geordie Andrews. Umpire says free kick to Carrara. So can they get a late one? It brings him in with a couple of goals. They'll be happy with that.
And again, look at this. No numbers forward of centre. Actually, Tippett's just creeping back now.
This is Betson. He's done really well. Brings it forward. Cleared away by Coolangatta. But the numbers are going to suit, again, Carrara. Oh, he misses his target. Kicks out wide.
And on the full.
So they'll reset. We're on 25, come at 24 and a half minute mark. There's still time. If they can get to bring it down to a smaller lead. Carrara, kick down, looking for a mark. Punched over the back. The ball again goes out of bounds. There's a bit of a lull, creeps into the game.
That's all you need to do though, if you're Carrara. You can't just allow these backmen for Coolangatta to sit free and just take intercept mark after intercept mark. Make them accountable, bring the ball to ground and make them earn it.
Special comments by Kane Browning as they kick the ball down the line, but it's beautiful mark taken there by Carrara. They kick across the middle of the ground. And again, just setting it up. It's a good mark there by Ridley. Ridley looking for movement. Kicks there, created a bit of space. That's a good work. Good blockage there where by Osman, who just created that bit of space. And has found a tip mark inside 50. So nice little play there by Carrara. They're coming back late, coming home with a run. It's good play, and he's going to have a shot on goal. So the work ethic and set up there by Ethan Mackey was fantastic. He's found his teammate in Adam Rockcliffe. And the ex-Tassie boy from Devonport will have a shot on goal to bring the Carrara Saints right back into the game in this grand final. He comes in. Oh, it's offline, unfortunately, for him and the Saints. The ball goes through for one behind.
Now, the last couple of times, Coolangatta have looked to move extremely quickly, straight up the middle of the ground. It's been cut off, and they've had shots on goal at the back of it. Carrara, great kick, though, coming out that time.
Magnificent kick by Hawkins. Blues, a turnover. Kerr. Strong today in defense. Left foot kick out wide. Nice kick. Good mark there by Rockcliffe. Handball over the top. Oh, he's got time. It's Ayres. He ducks and weaves. Kicks down the line for Seedy. Can't take the mark. The ball spills free. Swooping on the ball there is Cotty. He's tackled under pressure. Big Seedy goes through like a steam train.
He dragged that back in.
Umpire says no. And that crowd aren't happy. But they'll throw the ball up, Kane. We've played 26 and a half, approaching the 27-minute mark of the second term.
Geez, Easy just was a little bit fumbly when he didn't want to and wasn't able to penetrate with his kick inside 50. Ball rolls out of bounds.
Hawkins.
For another boundary throw-in. But again, it's all been the back end of quarters where you can feel Carrara just trying to get some ascendancy, especially in the contested side of the game. Because that's been an area Coolangatta have definitely been taking full advantage of.
Umpire Fraser's going to go in short. Taken away. He's quite mobile, the ruckman here in Betson.
Oh.
Unfortunately, he's kicked it out of bounds on
is
the full.
Is that 50? No. Decided to belt the ball over the fence. But the umpire said that's okay. Now where does Coolangatta go from here, Jack? Down the line? I don't think he should be switching the ball.
He's going to play the safe option. Kicks it high.
Oh.
Wow, gross. He just read it better than anyone else, didn't he? Umpire's call, play on. The siren sounds for half time. It's Coolangatta 6-4-40, leading Carrara 3-4-22 in the QFA Division 2 South Grand Final here at Surface Paradise. Kane, I'll just get your best players that you think so far. A quick summary of the first half before we go to a break.
No, look, the likes of Ayres, this is Carrara, the likes of Ayres and Gross and Kerr have been really solid. I believe they moved Ayres more so in that midfield towards the back end of that quarter. He got some ascendancy in that area, especially his spread. But, I mean, the likes of Carey, Kelly, Turner, Daniel Hawkins, Whitehead bobbed up and kicked a goal in that quarter. And you've also got, Mitch Carey bobbed up with a couple. So great quarter there by the Coolangatta Blues, and sets up perfectly after half time.
We have a look at the goal kickers before we go to the break. We've got Mitch Carey with two, Scotty Reardon with two, and then one each to Joel Tippett and Jake Whitehead. And for Carrara Saints, that's all individual goal kickers, one to Ian Osman, one to Jordan Andrews, and one to Dane Seedy. We'll be back after this break for this grand final. We look forward to seeing you in about 15 to 20 minutes' time.
My favourite things about being an umpire would be making friends, getting fit, and getting involved in the game. You're a big part of the game as an umpire, so it's a great way to get involved in the game.
What I love most about being an umpire is being involved in the game, even at my age and my level of fitness, and actually being able to be out there with a great group of people. It's fantastic.
What I love most about being an umpire is being involved with footy, making new friends, and getting paid to be involved in the game I love.
Definitely get involved. It is a great way to stay fit. It's a great inclusive community. It's a very supportive community, and it's a job that anyone can do. It doesn't matter about your gender, doesn't matter about your age, your fitness abilities. It's just a great way to be involved in AFL.
I would encourage anyone to get involved in umpiring. It's fantastic, it's fun, and you get paid to be involved in the sport that you love.
Well, welcome back to the QFA Division 2 South Grand Final. I'm Jack Barry. I'm joining the commentary box by with Kane Browning. And at the half-time of this Grand Final, it's Coolangatta 6-4-40, leading Carrara 3-4-22. I'm joined, as I said, in commentary box with Kane Browning. And Kane, how do you think this second half will play out? Carrara certainly not out of it at any stage, are they?
No, Carrara's done really well at the back end of quarters, being able to get some ascendancy in some key areas, especially in contested possessions. They've been really good at the back end of quarters, but the start of quarters, Coolangatta have just definitely got the ascendancy in those areas, and they've had so much room inside attacking 50. Tippett leads up to the footy. He's had 40 metres of room to lead into, and when the ball is... when the ball hits the ground, the likes of Carey and Lanyon and Robinson and Fenton, those small forwards have just dominated the ball when the ball's hit the ground, and they've had a number of opportunities, and especially Carey. Carey's bobbed up with a couple of beautiful goals.
You're right, it's been a really interesting battle, because if they kick it high, obviously they've got Tippett down there who can take a strong mark, but the work so far of Gross and also Kerr in defence have been pretty strong as well. But you're right, once it hits a deck, panic stations, those smalls are really busy, even though the only guy who's kicked two goals has been is Mitch Carey. But I think Lanyon, Robinson and Fenton, the boys you're talking about, have certainly been setting a few up.
No, Scotty O'Riordan has been really, really good in that first half. Just clean and smart with the footy. That's been the main thing. And that's been the main standout, really, the difference between both sides. Coolangatta get the ball in hands. They're not fumbly. They've been really smart with the footy. They're taking their first option, so that 20-metre kick, they're taking it every time. Just slows up the play and then allows them to kick over the line and set up the likes of Tippett, etc., to try and take a contested mark. Or, like we said, when the ball hits ground, the likes of Carey, etc., are really dominating that area. But Carrara, again, the back end of that quarter was really good for them. But obviously, the main target, the big fella down there in Dane Seed, they've got to move the ball extremely quickly into him, because any sort of slow ball movement, the likes of Kelly for Coolangatta are really seen up behind the ball well, and they're coming across and taking intercept marks. Yep. So they've got to be a little bit better in that area.
Manane, Watson, those types of players down there for Coolangatta certainly causing plenty of problems down there. The other one I've been really interested in has been the ruck battle. Of course, Turner, as we spoke a little bit about, you know, the Neefel star, 32 years old, played some great footy across there, but he's had a great battle with Tommy Betson, and Betson has been he's been really proactive again today. As soon as the ball hits the deck, he's quite mobile as well, isn't he?
No, Betson's been trying to work off him all the time, and especially at the back of that quarter, you saw on quite a number of occasions, Turner's just lean him go, roam around the ground, and he'll just set up a kick behind the ball, be that extra big body, so the ball gets quickly kicked out. He set up beautifully to take an intercept mark.
So Coolangatta leading this grand final, 6-4-40 to Carrara 3-4-22. It's been 20 years since the Blues have tasted premiership success, and they've certainly got a big, large following here today. And Carrara chasing their first one, as this club has built up from strength to strength over the last few years, and certainly are now becoming a really strong Gold Coast club and doing a great job as the administrators and coaches at Carrara.
Geez, it looks like Ronan Munro was lined up against the reigning league best and fairest in Tate Turvey in the middle of the ground, so that should be a really interesting battle.
Here we go, third quarter action. Up they go, tap forward by Carrara, swapped on top of the ball,
crunched.
And it'll be that Tate Turvey we spoke about. I think he'll get the kick out of the middle of the ground. Tate Turvey kicks it out forward. Is it going to be chopped off? No, over the top. Here's a chance now. We spoke about this, the youngster in Robinson. He gets a quick kick away. Ball spills in towards the forward line, and the tool will be taken out of bounds. I think Robinson's a young boy, come up from the Colts this year, and here he is playing in a senior grand final. So that's the beauty of some of these lower leagues, or when we've got young talent coming through the system and they can play in their own senior grand finals. Fantastic to see. Umpire throws the ball in. Strength. Turner gets a kick away. Swapped on there. Good, strong tackle there by, it might have been Rockcliffe who tackled him now. It was Kerr, of course. Throwing the ball up. Turner gets the ball. Kicked away by Carrara. The pack set themselves, but it was a good mark there by Mackey. Mackey gives the ball off. Goes in short. Here's a chance for Cunnington. Cunnington going to draw. Handballs to a teammate. The quick hand. The pressure's here. The umpire says a high kick. Is it going to quickly play on? No. Bring it back. And it'll be a free kick here going to Ian Osman.
Osmond's had a really good first half for Carrara. Again, they haven't had the ascendancy on the scoreboard, but the likes of Osmond have been really solid with their decision making, and it looks like it's not going to Osmond.
No,
you can't get away with that, boys. Handball it back.
It's a bit gentle.
Osmond's just a kick behind the play here. Straight to him. Osmond now it's his next kick. Look at Turner. Turner's 20 metres out. Just seen up behind the footy. Oh, crunch. Ez gets poleaxed. No 50 paid by the umpire. Now where's this next kick going? Hotspot, 30 metres out. No mark taken. Ball hits the ground. Coolangatta's got all the numbers. Tackle laid. Quick kick out. Beautifully set up though behind the footy.
Reardon's down in back play. He's got up very gingerly, skipper.
That was Kerr again, cutting that one off. Carrara now, kick inside 50, plenty of room. Pushed under the footy. Ball rolls over for a boundary throw in, Jack.
Well, they had the big CD on the lead, but he was probably eased under the ball, maybe trying to milk a bit of a free kick there. I think he just jumps and kind of catch the ball at the highest point. He'll be a real handful. I'm about to throw the ball in.
Now, you got Betson seen up behind the footy. But they look to have even numbers there, Cooley, so they've done really well.
Nice little tap out the back there by Seedy, but the ball goes to a holding decision and a free kick to Coolangatta in defence.
Now, where do they go from here, Jack?
I think this is Manane. Had a really good game so far. Goes in short. Nice little kick. So they've just got to work their way through. And Carrara got to create the pressure for a turnover. Big kick down the line. But
good,
it's a good mark and a good strong mark there, Carrara. They've come out of the blocks, have started well. Going to move the ball quick. Big kick.
Jeez, mate.
Front spot, if he can get it. Oh,
Osmond.
Couldn't take the mark. Snap over the top, it's gentle. And it's a goal. So the Osmond Gentle Show, we're just talking a bit about it in front of us. And they've teamed up again. And he's kicked his first goal. Sorry, it was 15. It was Mackey. My apologies. I think Mackey kicked that goal.
Yes.
Getting ahead of myself.
No, you're all right.
So, Ethan Mackey. Nice goal from a Southport Labrador. Played 14 games this year. Kicked 8. That's his 9th goal for the season. And they narrow the score. Coolangatta 6-4-40, leading Carrara 4-4-28, Kane.
No, 12 points the margin now, but that's exactly what they would have wanted to start this third quarter. Get the first one on the board. They did get the first one on the board in the second quarter, and all of a sudden Coolangatta came back with the next three goals, so they've got to be careful here.
Cleared away. It's Lanyon. Kicks forward. Bounces over the back. Where's Carey? Trying to win the footy. They're playing nice and tight on him this time, not letting him any space. A handball over the top. A quick snap out of the pack. It's going to go across the face of goals, and the ball hasn't gone out of bounds yet, but now we'll roll away, and they'll throw it in inside the forward 50 for Coolangatta.
And that's really an area where they've really struggled, Carrara, today. Having any ascendancy at all in the middle of the ground, I can't remember last time they had the centre clearance, Jack. They're really struggling.
Umpire throws the ball in. Tapped away. Kicked a socket off the ground. Turner puts his head over it. Good little play there by Carey. Umpire says there's a free kick in back play. And Carrara will take the kick in defence. Kicks out wide to Osmond. Handball over the top. Kick down the line. Can't punch to you. Here's a chance. Roved away here by Manane. Steps across. Goes in short and finds Hawkins. Hawkins squares the ball up. He'll have to be good. He does. Lovely laser kick. Good mark there to Elliott. Elliott spreads the ball across again. Building the play. This good play there by Lanyon. Goes in short. Oh, he doesn't miss his target. Now they're in trouble. Good pressure there by Andrews. Ball spills over the top. Whitehead going to get there first. Can't pick it up. Good pressure by Carrara. And the ball goes out of bounds, Kane.
No, it was Coat on that occasion. Just a little bit fumbly, unfortunately. He had the opportunity to kick the ball inside 50. Just couldn't get the ball in his hands. I think a bit of overthinking was done on that occasion. But second effort was good. He got back and laid the tackle and got the ball over the boundary line.
Umpire throws the ball in. Bounces over the top. Turner has a second swing at it. but it's going to be roved away. Oh, is he tackled high? Yes, he is. It's going to be
a
free kick.
Ayres again.
He's lifted his work rate. He sends the ball across the middle of the ground. Here's a chance. Cunnington handballs it. Lovely hands by Cunnington. Have a shot on goal.
Go, swing around.
As a miss there by Ethan Mackey, who's really starting to get his hands on it and trying to influence the game.
Geez, how good was that handball going inside 50?
Yes.
Didn't have to move, didn't have to break stride, unfortunately. Wasn't quite good enough to kick the goal on that occasion.
Great work there by Sam Cunnington. And it'll be Hawkins to bring the ball back in. He's a beautiful kick of the football. And he just does a lovely kick and finds Kelly. Kelly outside 50, looking for a teammate. Goes in short, it'll have to be a nice kick, and he's good, and he finds Matty Ryan. Ryan kicks it up. No one can really tip it. He's got time and space, so his teammate walked away, didn't see him there. There's a kick over the top here for looking for Robinson, but again, Carrara jumping on the ball. That's good play there, and the ball goes out of bounds.
I think that was Ralph on that occasion.
Harley Ralph. Happy to see the ball go out of bounds, Kane.
Now again, and just being clean. Just being clean takes a little bit of the pressure off when you're in a one-on-one contest, which is good to see.
Ball spills over the top. Ryan can't get his hands on it. Here's a chance for Carrara. Good strong tackle, but the ball goes out of bounds. And again, it's that man again. Ethan Mackey has really started to lift in this third term.
Daniel Carey, great tackle.
Josh Fenton coming on the ground for the Blues as they're ringing the changes. Also coming on is Nick Hamilton. They throw the ball in. Turner, no one can get their hands on the ball. Here's a chance now to Ralph again. Ralph tries to use his leg speed, but it's a good tackle. Play on's a call. The speedy Cody kicks the ball forward, but it's going to be sitting up there all for Manane if he can. He's got time and space. Can he find a teammate? He does.
Good
it's a
kick.
Lovely kick in the middle ground. He finds Hawkins, the veteran. Phases away, handballs over the top. Ball bounces forward. He tries to get the handball received. That's good play, and he'll clear the ball out, as he's done so many times in his stellar career. And he finds his teammate in Mitch Carey.
Carey ran 40 metres to take that chest mark.
He squares it up.
Good kick.
And he's found Josh Fenton. Handball's back. His Turner, he's got a big kick on him. Gets onto the left. Drives it long in the goal square. Tippett can't get it. Oh, it's Kirk off the pack. Great play there. I think that might have been James Roy's number 28. Just roved the ball off the pack there. That pressure kick inside 50 right into the mouth of the goal square. That both went to Tippett and the ball spilt free. And Roy's, I think it was, had just read the ball and kicked his first for the day. And brings the score to Coolangatta 7-4-45, leading Carrara 4-4-28, Kane.
Jesus, almost Carey's paddock down there. Just pushing players up the ground, Tippett was. And then plenty of room over the back, and Tibble ran in beautifully. Couldn't take the mark, but front and centre again, and Coolangatta get another one on the board.
So we've played just about 9.5 minutes of the third term, and they've just kicked one goal apiece this term. But Carrara looked like they've certainly lifted their work rate, but Coolangatta got the more importantly, they've got a score on the board. Again, cleared. This is the play we're talking about. Cleared out of the centre. Again, picked up and taken away. I really like the game of Will Manane today. He kicks the ball out on the wing, but the numbers are going to suit Carrara, but the pressure's coming from Coolangatta. Pressure, tackle, free kick this time, and they'll get the ball on the outer wing. They quickly want to move the ball. They want to get it down there quickly, as you spoke about earlier, Kane. Get it down to Big Seedy. Kicks it long, and they've found a teammate. Play on is a bounce. Keep the ball alive. Play on's a call. Manane's in now. Oh, is he tackled high? Here's a chance. The handball out the back. A kick away there by Nelson. He's looking for Seedy. There's 2v1. The other bloke down there again was Mackey, who's looking dangerous, Kane. The ball goes out of bounds.
Geez, great work there by Watson. Just getting back on the last line of defence on the big fella. Someone had to match up on him. 2-on-1 contest, and he was able to push the ball over the line, which was really impressive.
Carey coming off, and on gone is the youngster in Seamus Robinson. Umpire throws the ball in. Here's a chance. Jumped on top straight away, and the umpire will throw it up this time.
Yeah, they're going to try and sneak a goal here, Carrara, because they've had they've probably had more of the footy in this opening stanza of the third quarter.
The pressure's there. Manane.
Geez, he's dragged that back in. No.
It was tackled.
They've been pretty happy to take the ball up. There hasn't been too many occasions where guys have dragged the ball back in, so smart from both sides.
Let's watch the ruck work here from Seedy. He's got some ruck craft about him. Nice little tap out the back, but again, just watch if he can get a nice clearance here to and a snap on goal.
It's the one thing we've noticed all day, Jack. The amount of numbers Coolangatta get back and then spread once they get possession of the footy has been pretty dominant all day. So let's see what happens here.
Coolangatta got a big kick away. Young Robinson's there, can't get the ball. Here's a chance now, a quick kick. Oh, it's a snap, but it's turned over and it's marked by Ryan in defence.
Oh, hang on, he might have juggled that one. No.
Ryan drives the ball. It's a
wobbler kick.
They're looking for the DRS. We want to see that one. He's claimed the mark, but unfortunately, umpire says it was bounce and we'll throw it up. Thank you.
Again, umpire's a lot closer, so I'm just going to keep my mouth shut on that one. I definitely thought he took the mark on that occasion.
Fist coming out of there by Betson. There's been a few stoppages today. They're just going. The pressure from both teams has been pretty strong around the ball.
And the amount of room on that far side of the ground, plenty of space to run into if Coolangatta get clean possession coming to our defence here.
Punch forward. Good pressure. Can it keep the ball alive? Umpire says.
High tackle.
Free kick. So this is an interesting one. So Carrara will get a shot on goal. And this will try and. As a Coolangatta making the changes, and it's that man again. He's had a really good third term in Ethan Mackey.
He's had a brilliant third quarter.
Lifted his work rate, and he's impacting the game. And if he can kick this one, he's already kicked one. If he can kick another one.
Listen to the crowd going off, Jack. They're getting right behind this one.
Mackey allows for the wind. And just pushes across. It looked like he'd done everything right, but the wind didn't help him out there. So through for one behind.
Geez, all of a sudden you almost feel the breeze completely change direction, man. Yeah. Just as he was kicking the footy. So a bit unfair on that occasion for Carrara.
Hawkins sends the ball outside 50, over the top. Turner, handball, tip it over the top. Robinson doesn't bounce his way. Pressure, tackled high. Umpire didn't see it. Kicked away down the line. Bounces over the top. Punched out of there by Hawkins and the ball goes out of bounds.
But it's a chaos ball going in. They've got to try and change it up, Carrara, because they've been way too predictable going inside attacking 50, just aiming for the big fella at full forward in seed. You know, they've got to try and find option B, C and D, because at the moment, Coolangatta have got the numbers around that contest.
Tate Turvey, a quick kick away, Holland. Here's a chance now, Gross. Handball over the top, pressure, Rockcliffe. Just take the ball out of bounds. Crowd's getting up in arms, but it was all good and legit. And the umpire will throw it in.
Geez, Coolangatta, again, their ability to close the space quickly and not let Carrara get that overlap going has been really good all day.
Throw it in. Turner, big fist.
Got to go. Solid contact.
They've got no one forward. Here's a chance through the middle of the ground. Trying to keep the ball alive. Handball over the top. Roys kicks it high. But that's going to be all Carrara as they'll take a mark in defence and reset if they can. Through the middle. Drives it long. Did he hit him in the head? Kicked away. Nice by Hamilton. And he's found a teammate. And it's a good mark there to Reardon, the skipper. He's already kicked two. And he finds our main teammate unmarked, unchecked. And, of course, it's Gordy McMurdy.
Interesting name, Jack, but again, bobbed up in he was in the right place at the right time as the ball quickly came in. Another chip kick forward.
Loose checking.
Very, very bad defence for Carrara on that occasion. They've had three kicks within 10 metres and they've hit the target every time. They've taken the option, just move a little bit closer to goal. And here's someone you've been really impressed with in Will Manane. It looks like he's pushed up forward.
Well, he's done all the work in the back line. He's pushed in and found a bit of some space, and he's going to have a shot for goal. The ex-Echuca boy kicks it across the face and goes through for one behind.
This is going to be the second half of who can take their chances more than the other, because at the moment both sides have had a few shots on goal but can't quite get it through the middle of the sticks.
Big kick out. It's Kelly, goes in short. Doesn't quite make the distance. Handball's up. They've got time and space. Handball over the top. That's good work. Gets on the right foot. Has a shot.
I tell you what.
Is he kicked it?
What a goal! What a goal by Coolangatta. Not quite sure who that was on the far side. Geez, look at the numbers around him. Brilliant. He had no chance of kicking that goal from the boundary. Right foot kick, straight over the goal umpire's head. The ball came back beautifully, Jack.
A lovely goal. I can't quite see who it was. He deserves to be called out on that goal. It could be the goal of the day. I'm just trying to pick up who it was, but it was good work. He's running all the way back to the back line. So those goals can really lift sides, and that's a great goal. So he's pushed himself right into defence. I think if it was him, I'll try and pick him up. He's in the orange boots, number 32. If it was him, it was James Elliott. We'll confirm that a little bit later on, but we're going to give him the heads up.
Yeah, hey, and you know what? If it was him, he'll definitely take it.
Yeah, umpire throws the ball up. Seedy's gone into the ruck. Yeah, he's rucking up against Watson, and be a free kick in the middle of the ground to Lanyon, who's had a pretty good game. Lanyon goes out and they look for Tippett. He flies high. Ball spills free. Bounces at the pack. Bottom of the pack, Carrara got a chance to clear the ball out. Here they go. They've got numbers in support. Now over the top, Seedy. He gives it off. This is a good build-up.
Oh,
the pressure's coming. That's good play. Geordie handles over the top. Here's a chance.
Overlap.
This is good play by Carrara. All by himself. And runs into an open goal. You can put your glasses down. Bang goes Adam Rockcliffe. And that's a great response. Maybe Carrara's play of the day.
Jeez. You talk about overlap. That was the craziest amount of overlap I've seen all afternoon. They just had 6-7 spare numbers. And they were smart with the ball in hand. They weren't fumbly. One little fumble would have stuffed it all up. And great finish there by Carrara. That's exactly the goal they needed. And that's an instant response, Jack.
Yeah, Coolangatta 8-5-53, leading Carrara 5-5-35. As we approach nearly the 18.5-minute mark of the third term, as the sun starts to glare on that scoreboard to make it harder to read for us. But it's been a beautiful day here in Surfers Paradise, and we've got a good grand final, and Carrara will take plenty out of that. Umpire throws the ball up in the middle of the ground. Tapped over the top, it's going to be kicked away by Carrara. Can they get another one? Can they get back-to-back goals? Hawkins gets in front position. Clever little punch, but the numbers are going to suit Carrara as they kick the ball forward. Good work there by Gentle.
Good kick.
He gives them the goal square.
Great mark by Kelly.
Free kick. Kelly takes a mark. Good play. Defence. Settle it down, he says. I'll just chip across. Take a deep breath.
Kelly's been the man in that defensive unit, Jack, all day. He's been so impressive. And he really hasn't won a one-on-one battle yet.
Watson.
Sorry, lost a one-on-one battle. Sorry.
Yep. Carey's pushed down into defence now. Kick two in the second term. Goes in short again. Finds his teammate. So they're very careful with their possessions, Coolangatta.
Oh, good work there.
But the pressure was cut off and the ball will be thrown in on the outer wing.
That was Rockcliffe, the two on that far side, just coming across, punching the ball over the line.
Umpire to throw the ball in. Really good crowd today for this grand final. It's a nice one. Throws it in. In front spot there was Watson. He gets tackled there. Ball hits the ground. And the umpire says, I'll have it. Thank you. Of course, our umpires for today's game, we'll give them a bit of a shout out in Ben Cousins, Mark Viewick and Stephen Betts. They've done a great job. So umpire throws the ball up. Tapped out the back. Ball spilt free. And out of bounds once again.
Now Seed's pushed back down deep forward. And it looks like Kelly's matched up on him. Good luck with that. He's probably given away about 30 kilos. Oh, hang on. Someone's coming back now.
Yep, that's Watson.
And that's Watson. So Watson's lined up on the big fella.
Carey. Said about four possessions in the last couple of minutes. Kicks down the line, but it's a lovely cut off, and it's a good mark by Carrara. Now here's a chance to go a lovely
kick
in there.
Got to mark it. Oh,
he does, and it's a good mark there by Mackey. He's really lifted his work rate this quarter. Oh, gets a quick kick away. He's going to find a teammate. Can't mark it. Spills out the back. Whitehead clears the ball. It's a high kick.
Got to go.
Can't take the mark. Quick kick away by Betson. Inside 50. Handball over the top.
Dangerous.
Here's a chance. Swooping on the ball there is Hamilton. He kicks it out towards the members' wing.
Here's a foot race.
It's a 3v1 if they can get the ball away. They do get a handball away. Steps inside. Oh, the handball misses its target, and Coolangatta get a chance to clear the ball or just take it over the boundary line. and out of bounds. And that was Kelly there. As you said, he's been a bit of a general back there today.
But it's a chaos ball in again. Once the ball hits the ground, Carrara's working so hard to try and lock the ball in. Their small forwards are working really, really hard this quarter.
Throw it in. Tapped over the top. Hawkins gets jumped on. The champion. And they will throw the ball up. Representative state at Southport, represents Queensland country. He's been a great player over a long period of time, is Hawkins. Handball over the back. Play on's a call. Robinson, no, free kick.
Kicking in danger, said the umpire.
Harley Ralph. No, it's gone back to, it looks like it might be Ian Osman.
Osman's trying to push his opponent back a couple of metres. He's right on the 50-metre line. This would take a massive kick. Not sure if he has the distance here, but he's got the breeze on his back. He's been asked to play on now.
There's a free kick in the back play here.
Free kick down the ground for Carrara, yeah, I believe.
I think it was, there's been a bit going on between Ned Lanyon, who's got a heavy tag by the looks, or certainly going head-to-head with Harley Ralph, and then he's grabbed hold of him, and there's been a free kick in the goal square, and Seedy will have a shot to put his... the crowd aren't happy, they're up in their arms, but Seedy will have a shot to put his second through for the day, I think it is.
Yes, it is.
He
does. He's got it.
So, another good goal there to Carrara, and they're only a couple goals out of it. They're right in this game. So, Coolangatta 8-5-53 to Carrara 6-5-41, Kane. So, again, that's just a little bit of ill-discipline there.
Now Carrara paid for it earlier in the game, with some ill-discipline resulted in a goal, and all of a sudden they've got that one back, so they're probably even Steven in that area.
Yes.
But, and again, that work rate for Carrara at the moment throughout this quarter, when the ball hits the ground, they're starting to get on level terms with Coolangatta. We've gained numbers around the footy, and they've been clean around the contested possession, which has been a lot better since halftime.
Ashington's swung the changes. He's put Hawkins into the ruck. Here we go. Tap forward. Oh, strong tackle in the middle, but as Hawkins clears the ball out of the here into the forward line, ball bounces free, trying to tap it over the back, trying to stretch him. Carrara steady, kick long down the line.
Good kick.
And it's a good mark. Carrara have lifted, they're looking for another one. They go inboard. Good mark taken there by Betson.
They've got Ayres on the boundary line on that far side. They're not going to use him though. They go further.
Oh, it's going to be a free kick
that's
there.
That's got to be a free kick. And didn't need to do it on that occasion, the Coolangatta Blues player. I believe that was...
Manane.
That was Manane. Didn't have to go up. It was a two-on-one shot on goal, unfortunately.
That was Brennan, the skipper. But unfortunately, the ball goes through for one behind.
They've got to lock the ball in here now. Can they sneak one before three-quarter time and cut that margin even closer?
So it'll be... Will Manane to bring the ball back in. He want his time again. Lucky that we didn't go through for goal. Turner looks like he's going to come back onto the ground for Coolangatta. And
Turner definitely needed a rest. I'm pretty sure that's the first time he's been off the ground today.
Manane just goes in short and finds his teammate. He's lifted their work rate. Play on's a call. It'll be Carey out wide. And finds the other Carey in the number one, Mitch.
He's had a brilliant afternoon.
Yeah, Mitch Carey. Played forward and back. They swing the changes, don't they? Hawkins coming off the ground now.
They've got versatility, which I think Carrara struggles a little bit in that area. Play on called.
It's Carey to Carey to Carey.
Ball hits the ground now, and a free kick paid.
Oh, it's a free kick to Carrara for a shot on goal. This will be interesting.
Now, that was all about effort and second effort, third effort. Able to keep his feet, stay between his direct opponent and where the footy was bouncing, and got a little clip over the shoulder and got a free kick, Jack.
So, lining up for goal, I think, I'll try and see if this is Osman again.
Could be Osman. It looks like Osman out there.
See if we can zoom in and have a look who it is.
Geez, if it is Osman, he's had a brilliant quarter, and this goal would really set them up going into three-quarter time.
Might be the skipper, number four. We'll have a good look. I think it's the skipper. He kicks it high. It's Brennan. Punch through for one behind. It was the skipper. Yep. But like I said, he's had a couple of shots on goal, has Jaden Brennan. And unfortunately, he's missed them both, but he's leading his side back into this game. Big kick. Tippett can't mark, but it's a good mark taken by Royce. Royce. They're just really playing a bit of slow play here. Coolangatta go in short. Whitehead. Lots of calling from the boundary. He kicks it up high. This usually suits Gross. Can't punch it over his back. Punched over the top. That was Lopez. Couldn't take the mark. Swooping on the ball. Oh, he's taken high. And we have a free kick going to Carrara. So they've got another chance. They want to move the ball quickly. What do we play? 27-minute mark. Third term. Handball by the skipper. He gives it over there towards Gross. Gross drives it long. Oh, he wants that kick back again. Oh, they let it bounce. Here's a chance now. Oh, taken away again by Carey. He's going to be umpire said you were grabbed high. Don't get... Just need to play. They're not going to give any silly free kicks, Coolangatta.
Yeah, they got a couple of numbers on this broadcast side if they want to switch the ball. Again, it's that slow. Carrara's done well in this quarter, just being able to slow up Coolangatta's ball movement.
They're right back in this game. It's a big kick out wide. Can't take the mark as Robinson. Handball over the top. The
Look
pressure's
out.
Going to be Whitehead, big strong tackle. Kicked away by Betson, but it's all Carey in defence here. He goes across and short, finds his teammate. Oh, couldn't take the mark. Play on Zakel. He's got a chance. Handball forward. Oh. He missed his target. Carey again doing the mopping up. Smothered off the hands. Play on Zakel. Betson gets to his blow. Quick kick away. Trying to get the front spot. Here's a chance now. Carey again. He's done a lot of work this quarter. He's going to kick it out to Mitch Carey. But the siren sounds for three-quarter time in the QFA Division 2 South Grand Final. And it's Coolangatta 8-5-53 leading Carrara 6. I can't really see that.
6-7, I believe.
6-7-43, I think that is. So, Kane, we'll wrap this up with this quarter and we'll come back a little bit earlier and we'll talk about the last term. Welcome back to the final quarter action here of the QFA Division 2 South Grand Final between Coolangatta and Carrara. It's been a bit of a cliffhanger now. Coolangatta leading 8-5-53 to Carrara on 6-8-44. It's a 9-point ball game. I'm Jack Barry. I'm joined by Kane Browning. This last quarter looks like it'll be a thriller. Can Carrara come from behind and cause an upset here?
Well, Carrara set up beautifully through that third quarter. They started to get real ascendancy in the contested footy contest, and the likes of Turner, looks like Turner might line up in the ruck, and I reckon he'll ruck this whole quarter just to try and get some dominance out of that centre circle. But I've really liked Osman's game in that third quarter. I thought he really had quite a fair bit of the footy. He snatched a goal as well. He's been really good off that wing.
Right, Abby, running line for this last quarter. It's going to be a thriller here. The siren sounds for the last term as the umpire throws the ball up and Turner in the ruck. No one gets a clear tap, but it's sharked and kicked away there by Lanyon as he drives the ball forward in the four lanes. He found him, Tippett, he's got it! A quick clearing kick out of the middle of the ground Joel Tippett, my apologies there, Joel. A beautiful lead and a strong mark at centre half forward there. And he'll line up for the Mighty Blues and see if he can kick a goal and put his second through for the day.
He used his body work really early, Tippett, on that occasion, able to push off Lopez and took a great mark.
He kicks it nice and high. Is it going to swing around? No one can take the mark. It spills through for one behind. A sigh of relief there for Carrara.
Margin now 9 points, Jack. Now, Carrara's got to be really smart with the footy when they're coming out of the defence. You do not want to turn the ball over in this part of the ground.
Carrara bring the ball in, they kick out to the outer wing.
Big leap.
Fly, couldn't take the mark though. Ball spills free, bounces along the ground. They're trying to clear the ball out. There's panic stations in there already as they're both trying to take control of the game. But the umpire says, I'll have it, thank you. We've had lots of ball ups today. No one trying to just give the ball up if they can, trying to keep possession.
Now, Matty Ryan has lined up on young Osman on that wing. They're just in the middle of the ground at the moment. Really, really interesting contest between those two in this last quarter for sure.
Ball's going to go out of bounds in front of the beautiful big tree and they'll throw the ball up. It's a 10-point ball game, 54 plays 44 in the favour of the Coolangatta Blues.
A lot of goals kicked to this right-hand side with the breeze. Haven't had too many against the wind throughout this game, so Carrara's going to have to be good.
It's roved off the pack, kick forward, trying to take the mark, trying to keep the ball alive off the ground if he can get to it.
Fumble.
A handball forward, he's still in a chance, gets on the right foot, shots for goal, and I think he's kicked it, and that's Gordy McMurdy.
Hang on, umpires just want to check checking this one.
Is it a touch ball? They're feeling pretty confident.
Let's he's given for a point.
Okay. Well, he had a good close view of it, so one behind it is.
Jeez. That's the greatest celebration for a point I've seen in a long, long time, Jack.
Go in short. Here's a chance for Gross. Had a solid game in defence for the Saints. Gross goes in short. Oh, he's
Danger.
Turned it over. He's hit Ned Lanyon, who's had a pretty good game, Lanyon. Had some really good clearances. And Lanyon's going to have a shot he'll probably kick it from 50.
Now, he has really been the one bloke in that midfield battle that's really stepped up during this game. He's had probably 6 or 7 clearances for the game. He's been the one bloke that's really stood out in that area. And he gets to really punish the Carrara midfield if he kicks this goal. Beautiful
kick.
Kicks
it nice and high. It's going to swing around for one behind. So three points in a row there for the Blues as they're peppering away, but keeping Carrara in the game.
Every point's important, but I tell you what, if all of a sudden Carrara go run down the other end and kick a goal, Coolangatta will feel really filthy.
They're going to take the game on. Already it's on the outer wing. No one can take the mark. Spills free, but the numbers are going to suit the vice
Good
captain.
Good handball.
Here
we go.
Andrews. Handball over the top, but the numbers are going to suit. It's Carey again. He's had a really good quarter last quarter. He kicks the ball up high. No one can take the mark. Spills free. Front and centre suits Coolangatta. Handball over to Tate Turvey. He ducks and weaves.
Look at that.
Now the kick inside 50. This is a dangerous one.
That's a free kick.
He's taken a mark. Oh, he's dropped the mark. Trying to keep it alive. Here's a chance now for
Tippett.
A snap around the corner. And he's missed it. Through for another behind to tip it.
Geez, I'm surprised that wasn't a free kick. Deep forward. Both players seem to be holding and pushing and shoving. And
Let it go, yeah.
The Carrara bloke got sort of slung the ground. No free kick paid. Unfortunately, Tipper couldn't punish Carrara on that occasion.
So another behind. That's four for the quarter, I think it is.
Four and four.
Oh, it's a muck-up kick.
Danger, danger, danger.
Short. Oh, he's missed his target. Here's a chance for Tate Turvey. Puts his head over it.
That's got to be a free kick, and it is.
Yep, hang on. There's a bit going on.
Now, realistically, both players were trying to attack the footy, and, you know, Tate Turvey got so low to the ground, kept his feet going as well, and just got clipped over the shoulder. The free kick was definitely there, unfortunately, for Carrara. And here's a chance to put a little bit of a nail in the coffin towards Carrara. If you can knock this one over, this will be really good.
Still plenty of time. They've hit 4 points, so this is this is lining up for their first goal after kicking four. Tate Turvey. Lining up for goal. Western Tate Turvey comes in. Deliberate approach, and he's put it straight through the middle. So star players rise to the occasion in the big moments. And he's kicked a goal, and he's put Coolangatta's ninth through for the afternoon, 9-9-63, leading Carrara 6-8-44, Kane.
Jeez, again, Tate, he was so impressive there in that contest. The eyes only on the footy. It was a split second between him and his direct opponent. He was going to get their hands on the footy first. And it was the Coolangatta player on that occasion. Got the free kick. 30 metres out directly in front. Generally wasn't going to miss. Straight out of the goal umpire's head. And that really makes it difficult for Carrara now.
Back in the middle. Carrara looking to bounce back. And they take the game on. They look dangerous. So I think that's what the coach would have been instructing them to do. Take the game on. Again, out of the clearance.
There he is again.
Beautiful clearance away. It's a nice kick. He's going to find his... Oh, good front and centre. Handballs have slung away without the ball. Taken away there, quickly there by Brennan. Tackle around the shoulder.
Oh, clothesline.
And it'll be a free kick against Lanyon that time, and it'll be a free kick going to Ronan Munro. Ronan,
what's he doing?
He's trying to milk a 50,
what's
maybe.
What's he doing?
Maybe he's trying to milk a 50. Kicks off one step. He's going to find his teammate. He's got too much on it. Ryan can't take the mark. The athleticism is tackled high, but umpire says it's fair, and I'll throw it up, thank you. Right in front of the camera here today, and we'll see him go head-to-head. And they've got little Scott Ayres in there. He needed a lift if he can. He can be a real dangerous player. The rucks, no one contested. Skipper, that's Brennan. Kicks the ball down the line. Good play. Handball kicked away. That was game... That was Daniel Carey. Here's a chance, running straight through. I think he threw his head back. but I don't think he got him around the head. Good umpiring. And the ball bounces inside. Tippett, big clash. Oh, he's kicked it out of bounds on the full.
Good pressure by Tippett there.
Had to go. Lopez kicked it out of bounds on the full. They want to keep their head. The crowd there getting stuck in. Oh, and he's been caught, and he's
50. That's 50. That's
silly.
He didn't
need a free kick down the field.
Lopez got caught out. Really not smart at all. Right in front of the umpire. Umpire wasn't going to miss that. And unfortunately,
it's just down the ground. So it's a skipper in Scott Reardon. He's already kicked two.
Now, Reardon's doing the Babe Ruth thingy. He pointed to the goals. He looks confident in the distance. He's 55 out. Just chips it in short, though. There's Tippett, no mark taken. Tippett handball's in board. Here's Carrara's chance. Great tackle laid. No free kick. Turner's down back. Drops a mark. Handball's. Can't get any clear possession on that occasion. Turner gets wrapped up, gets crunched. Here's Carrara's chance. Got to be clean here. Good tackle laid. Oh, and Turner flips the player. Turner decided to do the WWE style. Just picked him up and dropped him. Free kick paid to Carrara, and now Turner's got half the team against him.
Well, Cunnington and Turner.
Oh, hang on.
They wanted to keep control here because Coolangatta are in front and they wouldn't want to be the ill-disciplined.
You don't want to give a 50 away here.
No. They just need to relax and get back on with the game. There's a grand final to be won. Cunnington is not walking past anyone.
Now as much as rough and tumble
now, this is now they've lost. Now he's been sent off with the yellow card, I think, has he?
No,
it's play on.
No, play on.
That was lucky.
Oh, the heat's really coming to this game now, Jack.
Yeah.
Both sides have got to be smart. Oh, hang on. Now the umpires have been pretty good all day with this sort of stuff. They haven't given too much away.
Just settle it down. We've got a bit of a blood rule.
And that is Turner.
Yep.
Turner's got to come off with a blood rule.
So Turner comes off the ground. Calm heads need to take control here.
If Carrara's going to get back in this game...
Umpires back in control.
They've got to be first to the footy, attack the footy with vigour, but be first to the footy.
Good solid tackle there again by Cunnington. Strong round the ball. Umpire to throw it back up. Good tap away. Good work there by Betson. Hawkins is strapped high.
Good tackle. Good tackle.
The umpire's just... he's just...
the umpire's holding on for dear life at the moment. He's going, look, I'm not calling anything at the moment. You guys want to push and shove, I'll just call play on.
Ball sitting in the pack of the bench. You've got to earn your kicks today, don't you? They're not just letting them go. The umpire's just... Plenty contested, can't send a fire. They're all having a bit of a laugh and they're playing nice hard footy.
Look at this. No one wants to give an inch at the moment. Both these sides. Plenty on the line. Clear.
Kicked away. Good by Brennan. Bounces over the top. Here's a chance now. Swoop on the ball is Ayres. He kicks it high down the ground looking for Seedy. It's going to go over his head and the ball's going to go out of bounds. So Carrara got a real chance here to regroup. 10-minute mark, 11-minute mark. Final quarter here. QFA South Grand Final, Kane. They've got to make a surge and they've got to make it now.
Well, they've got the ball at the right end of the ground. They really needed to kick a goal with this surge in play. Ayres has been good all day. And even that panic kick inside 50, at least it was to his player's advantage and not to a disadvantage where the Coolangatta defence could just punch the ball away.
Seedy just taps the ball, just goes down. He's got some nice, as I said earlier, some nice ruck craft. His tap work around the stoppage is pretty good.
Can't allow this ball to get over the back here.
Nice tap forward. Okay, it's just a real rugby scrum in there. No one can win that footy and get it out to someone with a bit of width, holding some space. So it'll be another throw up. Time ticking away.
Now we've got Brennan. Brennan's the spare man behind the play at the moment.
Taken away. Oh, it takes the game on. Beautiful. Drives it down the line. Here's a chance here for Carey. Got the front spot, but it's punched over the back. Umpire says a hand across the shoulder, and he'll get a free kick to young Mitch Carey. Both Carey boys have been outstanding this game.
The free kick was definitely there. Carey used his body extremely well. A little bit of cramp for Carey, which doesn't surprise me either. He's been working hard all day.
Kicks down the line. Oh, Tippett. Great work by Tippett. Used his body, just gave himself some space. Gets on the left, kicks into the pocket. It's the dead pocket, but he's got a found his teammate. Bounces over the top. Keep the ball alive if they can. Snap round the corner. He might find his teammate. Oh, he's got it. It's a good mark in the pocket.
That's 41 out there.
That's Whitehead.
That's Whitehead again.
Jakey.
All of a sudden, Whitehead's gone. He started forward, started the game. He pushed back in that sort of third quarter, and all of a sudden, he's ended up deep forward in that forward pocket roll again. And he took a brilliant contested mark.
He has a chance to kick. He's second for the afternoon, and more importantly, Coolangatta's 10th as they close in on their first premiership win since for 20 years. Whitehead, can he put it through? Has a shot on goal, right across the face.
Snuck in for a point.
One behind. This is what pressure does. So it keeps the door open ever so slightly for the Carrara Saints.
Geez, 9-10 to 6-8. They've really got to move. And again, play's getting pushed up the ground. They've got to try and keep their position. At least one or two of them for Carrara. Because if they do get the ball, when they kick the ball forward, no one's going to be there and Coolangatta will have all the numbers.
Look at them set up here now. They've got at least one spare, maybe two. Looks like they've got two.
Good tap forward by the ruckman. Done a great job today. Pressure. Tucker with got rid of the ball, but umpire says play on. Handball over the top. Gets a quick handball in. Being tackled without the footy, and it'll be a free kick going to number 27 in Ronan Munro.
Could get 50 if they're not careful. It's his free kick.
A bit of byplay there by Joshy Fenton.
Fenton just holding the ball up like on a silver platter for him.
Ronan kicks the ball high, pack fire, no one can take the mark. Good front and centre. Seedy gets a quick handball out of the top. He's got some real smarts about him. The ball doesn't clear, and the umpire says, I'll have it, thank you. Hoo-hoo-hoo. Approaching 14 and a half minute mark of the last term of this grand final.
Geez, they've moved Lopez down to full forward as well. He's deep forward. He's been playing on tippet all afternoon.
Can the Saints find a goal? They've got some bit of firepower up forward, but they've got to try and win this clearance.
They're one-on-one deep forward, Carrara, so that's what they want.
Tap out. Her kick still on the ground. Bounces.
Oh, crunch.
Free kick.
Oh, shirt front there. But that takes the pressure valve off for Coolangatta, and now they're out.
Elliot.
Side. This is Ryan. Ryan now. Chips the ball down the line. Ball rolling towards their boundary line. Stays in, just. Kick inside 50 now. One-on-one contest. Carrara go up, ball hits the ground. No one can take clean possession. Oh, crunching head-high tackle there. Free kick paid. Don't be silly, Carrara. Because you reverse it, your 10 metres out directly in front. And Carrara get away with that one.
They're holding it up. I think they've got to start playing on. They've got to start taking the game on. They wouldn't try and win this grand final.
Oof.
That's a nice kick on the outer wing. Can he find a teammate? He does a good, strong mark to Lopez. Lopez goes inboard, and it's too much on it, but it goes through the bowling. Here's a chance. Handball over the top. There was Hamilton. Goes backward to go forward. They'll switch it across. Hawkins will take the ball. This will be a nice kick. Just drills the ball forward and just finds his teammate. Beautiful little kick and a beautiful mark there to McMurdy. McMurdy gets onto the left, drives it forward in the bounds, pushed under the ball. The ball spills over the back and will go out of bounds. As time ticks away, Kane Browning, what do they need to do to win? 16 and a half minute mark of the last term.
Geez, they can't sit back and wait for something to happen now, Carrara. They've got to take every chance they can get. They've got to take all the risks in the world. They've got to be clean, they've got to be quick, and they've got to be precise because they're running out of time.
Marvellous effort by both clubs to get here. From where they've been over the years, they're really
dangerous.
Handball over the top. Punch forward. The Saints trying to hang on for dear life. Out of bounds. Umpire to throw it in.
And again, Coolangatta is pushing all the numbers up the ground. Carrara's got some extra numbers around the contest. But look at the free players for Coolangatta across their half forward line. They're set up beautifully if this ball comes out with a quick kick.
Brennan.
Oh, great tackle.
Brennan's worked hard for his Saints today. Handball over the top. And the ball goes out of bounds once again. So the time sitting in favour of the Blues. 9-10. 64. 6-8, 44. 20-point ball game. But there's still maybe 10 minutes left. A throw in. Punch forward. Coolangatta.
Good tackle.
Umpire said he got a foot to it. Lucky. Handball. Kicked forward again. Danger. No one can take the mark. Swooped on by Coolangatta. They're going to square the ball up. Looking for
good
Hamilton,
kick.
The wingman. But it goes over the top. Can they win? Here's a chance now for Crowe. Now they've got to go. Through the middle of the ground. Handball over the top. And they're off. And again, it's Ayres. Ayres goes back and forward over towards the vice-captain in Andrews.
But
he's fallen
bounce.
Over. And it's going to be Coolangatta. They repel the ball, go forward, and they're going to find a teammate. Great work there as Joshy Fenton takes the mark. Fenton looks for...
Good kick.
Tippett on the lead. Good defence. Punched away there by Kerr. Jump back on. Feeds back. Here's a chance now for McMurdy. He kicks it high, wide, but not handsome. And the ball will go through for one behind Kane.
Jeez. And again, they had the ball in open space, but again, having guys push up the ground, they had no one to kick to in attacking 50 Carrara, and unfortunately turned the ball over, and Coolangatta were pretty unlucky not to punish them on that occasion.
Big kick out, and it's just been another ball up. Fed a few ball ups. Young Mitch Carey comes onto the ground. Tippett comes off, hobbling. He's had a
He's been solid all day.
He's been a big target, hadn't he? He's had a solid battle.
That's all you've wanted. Yep. If he hasn't marked the footy, he's been able to bring the ball to ground. That's what you want from your full forward.
Kicked away again. It's been Heath Brennan. He's had a good day. Carrara tried hard. Just haven't been able to get enough inside 50s for the day. Kick over the top. But it's going to be that man again.
Oh, great mark.
And Will Manane had an outstanding game in defence today. Four-quarter effort.
He's been everywhere today, Manane.
Nice kick again. Finds Western Tate Turvey. Kicks forward inside 50. No one can take the mark. Spills free. This is where Coolangatta have been dangerous all day long. As soon as it hits the deck, they just swoop on the ball.
Oh,
just pushes his way through. Has a shot on goal. 3-4, one behind.
Jeez, he got a bit of a head-high tackle as well on the way through.
And the bloke has injured himself that who done the tackling. It's a quick play of the ball.
They've got to go now, Carrara. They can't sit and wait for some... Oh, hang on.
Hollands.
Wait for someone else to do it. They've got to come together as a team right here, right now, because if not, they're not going to get back into this game.
Roy's making him earn it. They've got to move the ball. We've got to go, Carrara. We've got to go. He's got nowhere to go. He goes in short. Now they're out. Here's a chance. Take away. Kerr, long down the line. Can't take the mark. Spills free. Turner's going to get the ball first. A quick soccer off the ground inside 50. Jumping in there is Brennan as he feeds the ball out the wide. Going out there towards... I think it's Ridley.
Got to go now.
They're moving the ball.
Here we go. We've got an overlap. Got Ayres.
Oh. Here the chance again.
Ayres is still there. No, not used. Kick inside 50. Great
mark.
This
is better. This is better. They need this goal.
It's when they've been able to get that overlap going through that part of the ground. They've been really dangerous. But it's just happened too few times throughout the day to really get that scoreboard pressure on the... Coolangatta Blues.
They need a goal for some self-belief to bring them right back into the game. 20-point margin, I think it is.
Geez, they've been peppering the goals this quarter, Coolangatta. Here he comes. And there it is. He's kicked it.
So that's a good goal to the Saints.
That gives them a sniff. They're close enough if they're good enough. We've played 21 just... bordering on 22 minutes in this final quarter. I believe it's 9-12. 9-12-66.
Second goal there to Osman. And as I said, he's been a real presence today.
To 7-8.
And he works hard up and down the ground on the wing there. So it looks like it's 66 plays.
50?
50, is it? Yeah, 56. So 16-point ball game. Ooh. In the favour of the Navy Blues.
They need the centre clearance, Carrara, right here, right now.
Oh, well jumped on there by Brennan. He tries to get a handball out the back, trying to soccer the ball forward. But Coolangatta have got the pace around the packs as they win the ball and drive it forward. Here's a chance for Carey, trying to work the ball out
danger
the back there.
Now.
Watch his little speed. Ducks and weaves, turns left and right, gets on the right foot, kicks forward into the forward 50. The ball might bounce out of bounds, and it does, and it goes out of bounds. The ball will be thrown in.
But again, Jack, how good have Coolangatta been just kicking to advantage, whether it's space or at least advantage side of their teammate to give them at least a 50-50 shot at it?
They've got some real good little leg speed too. You've seen people running away from stoppages or contested ball. When they've had that opportunity, they've been able to spread pretty well. Bottom of the pack, working over. I think their small men have worked in hard as well today. 23-minute mark time's ticking away. This looks like this could be heading down to Coolangatta Tweed.
Just keep an eye on Lanyon right here, right now, mate, because he might get this clearance here.
Well, there's a holding kick, and it'll be a free kick there to
Carrara.
So can they get the next one? Can they time their run perfectly? Stuck inside. Handball. Oh, they put himself under pressure. Gross. He's going to go out wide. This is where they need to go.
Danger.
The same there. Whitehead's there.
This is a 50-50
good
ball.
Good tackle.
Keep the ball alive. Whitehead, second and third efforts.
Oh, that's a great effort by Whitehead. That's brilliant. And that sums up Coolangatta's day this afternoon. Just getting in front of your man, between the man and the fall of the ball. One-on-one contest, had to lay the tackle or the Carrara out and running. Great work there by Whitehead.
There's been a great effort by Coach Mash Assenden to take the Coolangatta team to the grand final, as along with Shane Medley from Carrara Saints. Both these boys have done a fantastic job to bring these clubs and present them in the way they have. It's been a hard-fought contest. Turner, clearance,
but oh, shucked away by Brennan. And that's from the captain as well.
Blues, keeping the ball alive. Dirty kick inside 50. Bounces. Handball on top. Tate Turley.
Here we go.
Shoots for goal. Will this be
the
sealer?
For the premiership.
There it is. The sealer.
That will end it. That will just about end it, Jack. Coolangatta look to be all but home in this final quarter with that goal to the reigning league best and fairest from 2021. In Western Tate Turvey, great finish.
Well, that's his second for the term. Cometh the hour, cometh the man. And that's a big goal. And the Coolangatta crowd are up and about. It looks like the Premiership Cup will be heading back down towards Coolangatta for the first time in 20 years. And this once strong club here from the Gold Coast is getting a bit of its mojo back there. Colts played in the grand final yesterday. And new facilities down there, so a lot of people doing a lot of hard work, and it's good to see Coolangatta back amongst it.
Now we've got a 666 violation, I believe.
No, the runners or trainers.
Oh,
too
that's
sure.
It. The runners on that far side getting a little bit too close.
No. You're right. There's a mix-up here. They've got an extra short. So Carrara, one short in their forward line.
Jeez.
Here we go. 25 minute mark, 26 minute mark, up they go. No one gets a tap. Turner, the left foot juggernaut, kicks it wide, leaving the pack there is Carrara attacking the ball, caught with the ball, handball over the top, trying to keep the ball alive. They've got to risk everything they can. Taking the ball on is, I think that might have been Kerr, he's had an outstanding game, finds his teammate. They look really, really good when they run the ball. Kick down the line, here away they go. It leads Hawkins to the ball, handball over the top. Oh, he's going to get caught with the footy. No, he doesn't. He gets his kick away, but it's a quick kick inside 50. Trying to keep the back, they go back. That was Lopez going back. Kicks high into the forward line. Who can they take the mark? The Pack set themselves. Punched away there again by Manane, who's had an outstanding game. And Coolangatta will clear the ball over the top, and it's going to be a race for the ball. It's Lanyon who leads the ball. He's got the ball. He's going to get a teammate in front of him. He kicks it out in front. They've done this really well all day, but here's a chance now for Crowe. He's tripped over his own feet, and it's going to be taken away there by Fenton. Fenton kicks it inside 50. He found over the top. Here's a chance now for Coolangatta to run into an open goal. He shoots it well. He's going to kick the ball. Dribble, 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 dribble. It's through the Blues. It's all over. They're doing well. It looks like that could be the end of it. A great goal there to Coolangatta. And Kane, it was a good build-up from inside their defensive 50 all the way in towards the forward line, and they finished it off with a great goal to, I can't quite pick it up, it might be...
It was 28, I believe.
Yes, James Roy is kicking his second. He got the front and centre last quarter, and he's just finished it off with a nice dribbler, Kane, and it looks like it's the Blues.
And it's been that leg... We talked about it on a number of occasions, Jack, the leg speed, especially across half-back, being able to break away... Open some space up, and unfortunately the Carrara player lost his footing on this broadcast side wing, almost did the Franklin routine and leapfrogged his opponent, ran inside 50, beautiful kick inside 50, went over the back, and it was a great finish for the Blues again, just another nail in the coffin, unfortunately, for Carrara.
Turner will take the free kick. 11-12-78, 7-8-56. Turner will bring the ball back in forward for the Blues. He's had a great battle, Kane. I'll get you to have a look at your best players. I'll go through the goal kickers as we're winding up this game, coming to an end, a 29-minute mark approaching. As we've got a player coming off for Carrara. Turner, a thumping kick forward. Pack set themselves. Oh, Tippett! Strong mark as a strong mark is taken in Joel Tippett. Beautiful kick. And he'll have a shot on goal about 30 metres out, 35 metres out directly in front. And what a pickup this bloke has been for the Coolangatta Blues.
There's the siren. It's all over.
He's going to kick after the siren. Let's see if he puts it through. Tippett comes in as a crowd run onto the field. The umpire He's kicked it. And it's a goal of Joel Tippett.
Jeez.
And Coolangatta have won this premiership 12-12. 84, defeated Carrara 7-8-56. And Kane, I'll just get you a wrap-up of who you thought the best players on the ground were.
Jeez, look, for Coolangatta, I loved Wilmer Nain's game all day long. I wouldn't surprise me one bit if he won best on ground. He was all over the place, had plenty of possession, smart with the footy, smart by hand and foot. Great game by Manane. The likes of Turner and the ruck was brilliant. Whitehead, Joel Tippett down there just provided a target. Great way to finish for him too, kicking that goal after the siren. But Carey as well, Mitch Carey, bobbed up with three goals. He was brilliant as well. For Carrara, disappointing. Great effort during the year. Couldn't quite get the job done today. Came up against a red hot Coolangatta side. But the likes of Scotty Ayres was good all day. I liked Osmond's third quarter. He went out of the game in the last. Gross was good all day. Harry Kerr was good as well. And Dane C, the big fella in full forward, tried his best all day. But it looked like Coolangatta just had too many numbers across the board, and great win.
Also, like the game of Tommy Betson, the rucks were really good. Well, that wraps up our coverage here. We'll stick around and watch the presentation ceremony. But the day belongs to the Coolangatta Football Club, the Mighty Navy Blues, winning their premiership for the first time in the QFA Division South. And the premiers they will be. Don't forget, next week for more QAFL action, we've got the QAFL Grand Finals next Saturday at Cooperoo. But I'm Jack Barry, joined by Kane Browning, and thank you very much for watching the Grand Final today, and we look forward to seeing you next time we're here calling the next game.
Test, 1-2, 1-2, test, test. 1-2, 1-2. Can we have our teams over to the presentation area, please? Both teams. Can we have both teams to the presentation area, please? Can we have both teams to the front of the presentation? Good afternoon. On behalf of AFL Queensland, it's my absolute pleasure to welcome you all here to our QFA Division 2 South Senior Grand Final presentation ceremony. My name is Barry Gibson, Community Football Manager of AFL Queensland. Delighted to be your host. To assist with our presentations, please welcome to the stage Gold Coast Suns Academy Coordinator John Deeks and QFA Competition Manager Josh Rhodes. Well, first and foremost, what an incredible game. Certainly no place for the faint-hearted out there today. That was the contested game of footy as I've seen in a long time. Congratulations. Both teams had a red hot crack. Commiserations to Carrara, kept trying and pushing all day. And to Cooley, I think it's been 19 years and I think that was well worth the wait. Congratulations. We'd like to take this opportunity to acknowledge our umpires for the presentation of grand final medals, and I'll ask John to do the honours. Start off with our field umpires, Stephen Betts, Mark Buick, Ben Cousins, and in emergency, Lachlan Jones. Our boundaries, George Dean and Max Dean. And our goal umpires, Joe Bull and Liam Kelly. Please put your hands together for our umpires. Thank you very much for playing today, but throughout the course of the year. It's now time to move on to the player, adjudged best on ground today, and John will present that medal. We had three different groups of people vote today, and our winner for the best on-ground medal for the QFA Division 2 South Seniors from Coolangatta, number 27, Jed Turner. Ted, come on over.
Thanks everyone coming out today. Boys, is a good battle. It's a bit of white line fever for myself, so apologies for that at the end. But sometimes it's cool to stir the boys up a bit. But well done, Coolangatta boys. It's been a great year. I've loved every single bit of it, and every one of us deserve it. We've worked hard and done the work on the track and the shows today. So thanks, boys. Appreciate it.
That's it. Good turnout, ladies and gentlemen, our best on ground. I'd now like to invite the Carrara coach, Shane Lee, to come forward and say a few words on behalf of his team.
Bad luck, guys. Great year, effort. Wasn't to be today, unfortunate, so bigger and better things next year. Congratulations, Coolangatta, been the best side all year. Enjoy the day, and we'll look forward to the many clashes next year. So, well done, guys.
Thanks, Shane. Well done. It's now time to present our Premiership coach. I think, before I say, he was a tad intense throughout the course of the game. Hopefully he can relax a bit now, as he gets his Premiership medallion and the match ball from John. Please welcome your Premiership coach, Matt Ashenden. What on, Matt?
Teacher. Oral presentation, here we go. First of all, to Carrara, an incredibly well-run club. Darcy does a wonderful job, so well coached. Shane and Wayne do a wonderful job as well. That was a cracking game of footy. Your intensity brought out the best in us, so well done on a great season. Wasn't your day today, but you should hold your head high. You played really, really well. So the Cooley boys, the lab and the committee, the work and the effort that you guys have put in to get this club where they are, I think, can't be overstated. So thank you so much to everyone on the committee,
to Sangers and the footy ops, we had some clashes throughout the year, but your support and the work that you've done has been brilliant. To Chris and Brenner, our physios and people who have got this team on the field today, which most of them wouldn't be without you two, so thank you so much. To our premiership water boys, Nick and Pidge. Heart and soul of the footy club, they're fantastic people. I'm so happy that they get to experience this. To the coaches, Zach, Hemo, and Chuka, who did everything he could to get on the ground today. Thank you so much for your help throughout the year. You guys have been sensational. To the families, I know it's difficult. My wife's a bit of a sole parent during footy season. I know we've got a lot of young families here. Thank you so much to the families for your support. To the supporters that showed up today, thank you again. Couldn't got over line without you. And last and certainly not least, this playing group, thank you so much for what you've done. Thank you for the way you've played. Every time I asked for something, you answered. You guys are brilliant. Thank you.
Congratulations, Matt Ashenden, our premiership coach. It's now time for John to present our premiership players with their medals. And we'll start off with number one, Mitch Carey. Number two, Ned Lanyon. Number three, Connor Robinson. Number four, Joshua Fenton. Number five, Dylan King. Number six, Weston Tate Turvey. Number seven, Will Manane. Number nine, Nick Hamilton. Number 10, Jordy McMurtry. Number 11, Bo Kelly. Number 12, Matthew Ryan. Number 13, Clyde Milroy. Number 15, Seamus Robinson. Number 17, Lachlan Watson. Number 21, Joel Tippett. And our best on, number 27, Jed Turner. Number 28, James Royce. Number 31, Daniel Carey. Number 32, James Elliott. Number 39, Daniel Hawkins. Number 41, Jake Whitehead. And your premiership captain, number 23, Scott Renan.
I'll ask Scott to stay on stage, and Matt, if you could come back. And I'll ask John to present the Premiership Cup and flag to your QFA Division 2 South Senior Premiers, the Coolangatta Blues!